Hello everyone, welcome to Computer Science and IT Gate Coaching. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to get the instant notification of my free lecture.
So this is about me. I am a Computer Science Gate faculty having more than 5 plus of teaching experience, mentored more than 50,000 students, taught in different coaching institute all over India. Okay, it's like the Gate Academy, even qualified multiple times Gate. And even I have given the coaching in many government colleges as well as in many private colleges. Like in SRM Chennai, I have given coaching. CET Bhubaneswar, I have given. BC Bhagalpur, Jorhat College of Engineering, Guwahati University, Dibrugarh University, Government College of Engineering and Technology, Jammu, Ramgarh Engineering College. Okay, these are the colleges where I have went and I have given the coaching. We are going to see Prim's algorithm. So in previous lectures, we have seen a spanning tree. So what was the spanning tree we have seen? Spanning tree is a tree which is going to connect all the nodes or vertices of a tree with minimum number of edges. So we have seen application of a spanning tree. Application. What was the application? To find the minimum number of nodes. Okay. And that we are going to use in minimum cost spanning tree. So today we are going to find minimum cost spanning tree. Okay. Minimum cost. So please try to maintain the attendance and live class. You should attend my live class. Wherever you will face the difficulty, I am always ready to take your doubts. Okay. So minimum cost spanning tree. So what is minimum cost spanning tree? There they will give you one graph. They will ask you what is the minimum cost spanning tree. Means if you want to connect all the nodes of the graph, but the edge should have minimum cost. So like if you are having from Kolkata, you want to go to Bangalore, and there are many ways, by my many ways you can go by this path, and it is having some cost associated. So to go from here to here, like to go Bangalore, you are first going Hyderabad, here you are going Pune, from Pune you can go also Bangalore, and one is like direct. Okay, so if it is having 10 and 2 and if it is having 5 and 4 and if it is having 20, then you have to find the minimum cost. Spanning tree means you should connect all the nodes, all these four nodes in such a way that the cost should be minimum. The cost means you should even go to Hyderabad, Pune and Bangalore, but your cost requirement should be minimum. Okay, that we are going to see here. So if you want to travel to some set of places, okay, always you want to go all the vertices, but your cost should be minimum. So here we are having a two algorithms by which we can find the minimum cost spanning tree. One is Prim's algorithm, another is Kruskal algorithm. So both we are going to see, but Kruskal we will see later. So if you will use both the method, either Prim's or Kruskal, you are always going to get a correct answer. Both is going to give a correct answer, but we use some in some problem and other in another problem. So it is having a different kind of approach. Okay, that's why it is having a different problem. So now we will start with the, so Prim's algorithm we will start first. So in any place, if you have the doubt, feel free to ask me. Okay. Prim's algorithm. So step one is saying that first connect the, and please try to share the link of my class to the groups and in your account, like in Facebook. So this will just be a help from you people for me, so that I can get more student in my class. Okay. So it's just a request from my hand, from my side. Okay. So first connect the two nodes with minimum weight. So first you connect the two nodes with minimum weight. You have to connect the two nodes with minimum weight. First you connect the two nodes with the minimum weight. Then step two. See, this step we are always going to follow. This way if you'll keep on see, you can see me that I keep on sharing all my links in LinkedIn, Facebook, in everywhere, in WhatsApp, in every profile, so that I can get the student, those who want to study. Okay. And even our class attendance should get increased. Okay, so if we get a more crowd, it will be even beneficial for you people also and for me also. But if you will get a more group of students who are focused on GATE and who are means really focus, not like just giving. Okay, serious student you will get. So that's, you will get a very good competition also. So step two is, and then from, as then from the two nodes connect the node with least weight with least weight and so on. So step two is saying that, and then from the two nodes connect the node with least weight. Means first we will connect the two nodes which is having a minimum weight. Then from these two node only that we have chosen, we will see the adjacent nodes and we will choose the node which is having a least weight. Okay, and so on, like we will keep on doing. See, with example it will be more clear. Okay, so if you are done with the writing, then please comment D. We will take the example now. We will solve many problems, then later we will see previous year gate questions also. Okay, and implementation also we are going to see. So please comment if you are done with the writing. You can comment and you can like this session. And those who are watching for the first time, you can subscribe this channel. Yeah. So now take an example. So if I will give you a graph like this, I'll give you a graph like this. So you are having a, if you are having a graph like this, so it is having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 node name, and ages, weight is 10, 14, 28, 16, 12, 18, 22, 24, and then 25, and then 25. Now this is the graph. See, this kind of questions they will ask in your gate. Now this is a graph, and then they ask you what is going to be the minimum cost spanning tree. So Prim's algorithm is first saying that first connect the two nodes with the minimum weight. So first connect the two nodes with the minimum weight. These two node is having the minimum weight. These two node is having the minimum weight. Okay, so first I'm going to connect 1 and 6, which is having the minimum weight 10. Then with these two node, connect the nodes, another nodes, see, and from the two nodes, okay, these two nodes, connect the nodes with least weight, means the nodes which are adjacent to 1 and 6, you connect the node which is having the least weight, like from 1, the adjacent node is 2, and from 6, the adjacent node is 5, yeah, Prim's is greedy approach, yeah, correct approach. So if you'll see, which one is the least one, 25. So you will connect from here, we'll connect here. Now out of these two, you will see the adjacent node which is having the least weight, you will connect. So here 22 is there, 24 is there, here 28 is there. So 22 is having a least weight, so you will connect the node 4 from 5. We'll connect the node 4 from 5, and it is going to have a weight 22. Now from 4, you are having 4 and 2 and 5 is there. Now from 4 you can connect to 7 3, here its weight is 12, here is weight is 18. From 5 you can connect 7, here weight is 24, and from 1 you can connect to 2, where weight is 28. So this three is the adjacent node. Okay, from this, the nodes which we are having in the tree. Now from this, we need to connect the node which is having the least weight, which will take the least weight. Least weight is here 12. If we connect from 4 to 3, we will get a age of least weight, that is 12. So I will take 12, means node 3, 12. Now see, only one node is remaining that we need to connect is 2. Now 7 is also remaining, 7 is also remaining, and 2 is also remaining. Now from 3, the next adjacent node is 2, which is having a weight 16, and now from From 5 you are having, you can connect to 7, and from 4 also you can connect to 7, here 18 weight, here a 24 weight, and from 3 you can connect to node 2, here weight is 16, here weight is 16, okay, from 1 you can connect to, okay, minimum cost, say, from 1 you can connect to 2, weight is 28, so which node you will connect now, you will connect to, and by which, how you are going to connect to? So you are going to connect to by either 1 or 3, which you are going to connect by node 3, because here weight is 16. So you will connect 3 to 2, this node is 16. Okay. Now you are going to connect, only remaining node is 7. How you can connect 7? You can connect 7 by which node which will have the least weight. See, you can connect from 2 to 7 also, 5 to 7 also, 8 to 4 to 7 also. But which will have the least weight? Least weight is having here 14. We will connect this. So this is your minimum cost spanning tree. See, if anyone having any doubt, please feel free to ask me. I can repeat the concept. If you are having doubt in any place, feel free to ask me. अगर किसी को doubt है तो बोलिएगा, ठीक है? Doubt है तो आप comment कर दीजिए, मैं आपको बता दूंगा फिर से. Minimum cost spanning tree. ये हमारा क्या हो गया? This is our minimum cost spanning tree. And you can add all the cost. And you can add all the, yeah, this is your graph they have given. They ask you the minimum cost sparing tree. So you know that if you are having a n nodes, then how many edges you will have? If you are having a n nodes, then number of edges you are going to have n minus 1 edges. N minus 1. See, number of nodes here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 nodes is there. How many edges you are having? 6 you will have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So step one is saying that first connect the node with, first connect, I am just erasing, you just see the example again. Now see, which is having a least weight? 10. So you connect the node which is having a least weight. So you will connect the node 1 and 6 which is having a least weight, 1 and 6, least weight. Okay, you have connected 1, 6 which is having a least weight. Now you will add the node which is adjacent to 1 and 6 which is having a least weight. So from 1 you can connect to 2, you can go to 2, and from 6 you can even go to 5, but you should go to the node, which node, where which is having a least weight. So this is, if you'll go from 6 to 5, it is having a weight 25. So you should go to 6 to 5 which is having a weight 25. Like this, I will always repeat this process. I will always see the node which are adjacent to the nodes which are present in the tree. It is in the process, we are constructing a tree. Now in this process, whenever you will choose 2, the answer will be incorrect, because you need to construct a minimum cost. The cost should be minimum. Okay, to connect every nodes, see, what is the minimum cost spanning tree? To connect every nodes of this tree, the node, the number, the weight should be minimum. The cost should be minimum. Okay, the cost should be minimum. So from 1 to 6 you have connected, the cost is 10. From 1 I have connected 6. Now the adjacent node here is 2, and now from 5 adjacent node is 7 and 6. Now which node should we connect? Whether 2, 7 or 4, we'll connect the node which is having a least weight. So if we'll connect the node 4, I am going to have a least weight 22. I will have the least weight 22. So I should connect a node 4 which is having a least weight. Okay, so this way you have to choose. Means if you want to go from Bangalore to Kolkata, then you should choose the path which is going to incur less cost. Less cost. Okay. So from Pune to Bangalore, if you will go, then it will, let's assume it's taking more cost. But if you will go from Hyderabad to Kolkata, then Bangalore to Hyderabad, then to Kolkata, then it will take less cost. So generally, from Hyderabad, the cost price is less. So we should traverse from that way. Okay. This is the way we should traverse. Now, you are at place 16654 is there. Now connect the node which is having a least weight. So from 1 again you can connect to, weight is 28. But you can even see here, from 4 if you'll connect 3, the weight is 12. This is the list. Because from 4 you can even connect 7, but the weight is 18. From 5 you can connect 7, but the weight is 24. So you should connect 3 now. You should connect 3 now, and it will have the weight 12. Now same way, you should connect from 3 to either 2, from 3 you can connect to 2, or from 4 and 5 you can connect to 7. Okay, but which one you will choose? Here the weight incurred cost is 16, here 18, and here 24. So you should connect from 3 to 2. 3 to 2. 3 to 2. Okay, 3 to 2. Because it is going to cost less. Okay, from 2, the only node is remaining is 7. And all the remaining node I have connected. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 node we have connected. So to connect 6 node, we will require 5 edges. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Because it's a tree. In a tree, if you are having n nodes, it will have n minus 1 edges. Now you need to connect 7 only, remaining node. So you can connect 7 from 5 also, 4 also, from 2 also. But you should choose the path which is going to incur less cost. So you will choose the edge which is going to have least weight. So you will choose this 2 to 7, which is going, means from 2 you are connecting to 7. Now this is your minimum cost spanning tree, and the cost incurred you need to add that 10 from 10 plus 25 plus 22 plus 12 plus 16 plus 14, and two students have calculated this sum and they have told that it's 99. So its answer is, in gate exam they will give you a graph. They will ask you what is the value of minimum cost spanning tree and what is your diagram. So if you are done with the writing, please comment D, and please like the session. And those who are watching for the first time, those who have not subscribed the channel, you please subscribe it. Now I'm taking the next question. I think that everyone is done with the writing. Is it? Yeah. Now see the next one. Now see the next question. We will take many questions. We will even take gate questions also. So this is having A, this is having a B, and this is having a C, and this is having a D, and this is having E, and this is having F, and this is having G. Okay, so I have taken this. This is going to erase. If I will draw in that way, it will take more space. So I should draw a little bit small so that I can draw the minimum cost spanning tree here only. So in this way, the tree is there. The graph is like this. So now this is the graph, and we are going to construct a minimum cost spanning tree. So first our work is to choose the node, two node which is having a minimum cost. See, so A and B, this edge is having a minimum cost. So I will connect A and B, which is going to have a minimum cost 1, A and B, which is having minimum cost 1. Now by A and B, which node I should connect so that it can it incur less cost? So I should connect C, because from A I can connect to C also, from B also I can connect C, from B I can connect to D, from B I can connect to E. But the least cost is here 4, least cost is here is 4. So I should connect from B to C, and cost is going to here. And see, after that you should not connect A and C, because if you will connect A and C, then it will be a cycle. From A to C, from A to C, if I connect, then it will be a cycle. Now I should not connect A to C. Okay. See, because a tree is a acyclic connected graph. Acyclic means no cycle. Okay. So a tree is a acyclic connected graph. So it should not have a cycle. Now from B and C, what are the nodes you can connect? You can connect to, from B you can connect D, E, and from C you can connect F. And least weight is here is 2. Least weight here is 2. So from C you can connect. From C you can connect to F, which is having a least weight 2. Now F, and from C and from B you can connect to this also, and this also, which is having a least weight. This 3 is having. So you can connect from F, you can connect to now E is having a least weight 3. Now only node that is remaining is G. You have connected all the nodes. Now D is also remaining. You need to connect D also. Now how you can connect D? By B also, by C also, by F also, by E also. So which is going to incur less cost? By C. You should connect by C. Okay. Now only remaining node is now G. So G you can connect by E and by F. So which is going to incur less cost? If you connect from E, so you should connect from E and it is going to incur less cost, that is going to T. Okay. So in this way, we are going to find the minimum cost. Is it clear to everyone? If anyone is still having any doubt, you can ask me. किसी कोई डाउट है तो पूछ सकते हैं, ठीक है? सो इट इज गोइंग टू हैव 1 प्लस 4 प्लस 6 प्लस 2 प्लस 3 प्लस 10, सो इट इज गोइंग टू हैव हाउ मच? इट्स योर 10, 20, 25, 26, या करेक्ट. सो यू टू टेक द नेक्स्ट ग्राफ वेयर यू विल सी द टू नोड्स, टू एजेस विच इज गोइंग टू हैव ए सेम वेट, विच इज गोइंग टू हैव ए सेम वेट. सी वेन एवर देयर इज ए ग्राफ विच इज हैविंग एजेस, which is having a same weight, then you can get more than one spanning tree. See, you can write, if you are having, if in a graph, so please write it, it is important, okay? Because now we are going to see some complex one. If in a graph, whenever we have same weight for more than one edges, then there is a chance. So whenever we have some weight for more than one edges is going to have same weight, then there is a chance, but not always guarantee, okay? But there is a chance, but not always possible. That we may get more than one spanning tree. But the cost is going to be same. That is, minimum cost is going to be same. Okay. So it will incur the same cost. If you are having a more than one spanning tree, also if you are getting, you can have more than one spanning tree, but it will have a same cost. Okay. Now let me take the example. With the example, it will be more clear. Let's take the example. With the example, it will be more clear. So A, this is A, this is B, and this is C, this is D, this is E, this is F, and this is G. Okay. So your, I'm connecting this. It is having a weight 2. Okay. It is having a weight 12, it is having a weight 6, it is having a weight 10, and it is having a weight 5. And it is having a weight 7. Okay. Now we will start our process. So I have connected the graph here. Now solution. See, you need to choose the nodes, first two nodes, which is having a least weight. Now see, you can choose AB as well. You can choose AC as well. You can choose BC as well. Now see, there you can start with either AB, AC, or four spanning tree. Okay Bhaskar, so you can connect first, so you can choose any of this, you can even choose CD first, okay, because there you are having a four choices four edges are having a same cost, that is one. So first I am connecting A and B. Okay, you can choose any one, but let me choose that A and B. Then from A and B you will connect the node which is having a list width. Now from A you can go to C, or from B you can go to C. From both, either from A or from B you can go, and both is having a cost one. So it will be give the same answer. It will give the same answer because you can choose. It is also having the least weight one. It is also, so you can choose any one. I am choosing the C. I am choosing C from A. Okay. I am choosing from this. Now from A and B you can connect to E, D and F. Now you will choose the next node. See, here always we are adding the next node. Here always I am getting a tree. It is a tree. Here always I am, from the tree I am choosing the next node, the node, and which node? From going to the this or this node, the cost should be less. Now from C, if I'll go to D, the cost will be 1. The cost will be 1. See, I am not choosing from C to B, because if I connect these two, it will be become a cycle. Always please remember, a tree is an acyclic connected graph. Acyclic, it's a definition, standard definition. A tree is acyclic, means no cycle, connected graph. Okay. Now from D, C and B, you can go to E, F. Now from D also you can go to F, cost is 2. From C also you can go to F, cost is 2. So whichever you feel comfortable or anything. So I am going from D. Cost is 2. Now you need to connect from now adjacent next node, which you should choose. Here if we'll connect next node from B, from B, D, F is, from B if we'll connect E, cost is 7. From D if we'll connect E, cost is 5. From F if we'll connect E, cost is 6. And if we'll, from F if we'll connect G, cost is 12. So minimum cost is getting, we are here, 5. So from D we should connect E. Here always we are getting a tree. Now the next only remaining node we are having is G, and we should connect from either, we are having a two path, two way we can connect to G from 6 or F. Now which I should choose? The edge E to G. So from E to G, because it is having a list. This is one spanning tree you have got, or another you can make. So many spanning tree you can get if you are having a miss. There is a chance you may get. Okay. Like A, B, C is there. D is there. Yeah. See, next spanning tree I am giving. Next spanning tree from this. Now, next spanning tree I am constructing. Now, see the cost here. So here minimum cost is going to your, mean cost is going to your 3, 2, 5, 5, 10. 5 plus 5 is 10, 10, 20. So its cost is 20. Now another way we are going to construct. Okay. This is another way. So A. So first we should connect. Now first here I have taken AB. Now I am taking BC. Now you can connect to A by either B or C. Take anyone. I am taking. Now C to D, 1. Now to connect F, you can go to either D or from C. I'm going from C. Now it is having E and G. Now to connect E, I should use the path I am having 5. From D, B to E, I can go, weight 7. From D to E, I can go, weight 5. From F, I can go to E, weight 6. So from D also I can go, because it is having a list weight. Awesome. And from E, again we got another spanning tree. This is another spanning tree. Same way you can again got another spanning tree. Okay. So if it is having, if you are having a edges which is having the same weight, then you can get a more than one spanning tree. There is a chance. Not always possible. There is a chance. Okay. So if you add this, 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 3, 3 to 5, 5 plus 5 is 10, here 10 plus 10 is 20. So all the different spanning trees also going to have the same cost. It's 20. So now we will see previous year gate question. So before going to previous year question, I am having a one question. So before starting previous year gate question, I am having one question to all of you. Okay, let me write that. So first you think, then you should answer that question. Okay, this is going to be some one of the tricky question. So I think that you have written that one. Okay. So the question is it always true? Is it always true that the age, is it always true that the age with least weight should always be present in minimum cost spanning tree? This is the question. Okay. So the question is it always true that the age with least weight should always be present in the minimum cost spanning ट्री? मैं यहां पूछ रहा हूं, क्या यहां जब भी आप मिनिमम कॉस्ट स्पैनिंग ट्री बनाएंगे तो जो एज का लीस्ट वेट है वो क्या हमेशा ही आपके आंसर में मिलेगा, मतलब मिनिमम कॉस्ट स्पैनिंग ट्री में मिलेगा? क्वेश्चन आई एम आस्किंग दैट इफ यू आर हैविंग एज विच इज हैविंग ए लीस्ट वेट, सो दैट एज इज गोइंग टू बी प्रेजेंट इन ऑल दी स्पैनिंग ट्री, ऑल द मिनिमम कॉस्ट ऑलवेज इट इज गोइंग टू बी प्रेजेंट इन दी स्पैनिंग ट्री? नो, सी हियर दिस नोड ए सी इज हैविंग ए लीस्ट वेट, लीस्ट वेट, बट इट इज नॉट प्रेजेंट हियर, इट इज नॉट प्रेजेंट हियर इन दिस मिनिमम कॉस्ट स्पैनिंग ट्री. Here it is present. Here it is present. So it is not always true that if a age is having a least weight, then it will always be in the minimum cost spanning tree. Okay. Understood na? Anyone is still having doubt? किसी को doubt तो पूछ सकते हैं. देखिए थोड़ा complex है. It is little bit complex. If you are having doubt, you can ask me. Right? Now, when it is always going to be possible, it is only possible it is only possible when there is only one age which is having, so when there is means all it is having a distinct weight, not it is having a same. So it is only possible when there is only one age which is having, which is having, which is having least weight, which is having a least weight. So it is only possible if that age is only one which is having a least weight. Okay. Or when it is possible, or if you add this, or it is possible. So there are two ways, two condition it is possible. One, if it is that age is the only one age which is having the least weight. Okay, so if all the ages are distinct, then it is possible. And when by adding that, if it is not forming a cycle, if you add AC, it will form a cycle. Or if you add AB, it will form a cycle. So both condition, in both way, it will be possible. Very good. So, or it is possible when by adding this age, it should not form a cycle, it should not form a cycle. Very good. See today class, you can see that how the comments and all these things are coming. So if you are having a good strength, it's see your participation is very good. I am getting the answer from you people. Okay, so that's we require. Okay, that is the requirement. In gate 2010 they have asked, in 2010 they have asked. Now they are asking you to construct the minimum spanning tree, construct the minimum spanning tree from the weight matrix, from the weighted matrix. Means they have not given a graph. Okay, they have given the graph in case of weighted matrix. Okay, means from A to B, if you want to go, what is going to be the cost that they have given? Okay, let me, like here, so weighted matrix is like, if you want to, just like see here, if you want to go A to B, It will here it will write the all the nodes here also from A to A. A to A, what is the cost you incur? 0. From A to B, what is the cost incur? 1. So they have given a weighted matrix. In GATE exam, they have not given a graph, they have given a weighted matrix, and they have asked in GATE 2010. So they are asking you to construct a minimum spanning tree from the weighted matrix, and the matrix they have given is this. It is having 1, 2, 3. Here 1, 2, 3. Okay. It's having a cost from 1 to 1, 0. From 1 to 2, it's 10. From 1 to 3 is 30. From graph represent in memory by matrix and by three way it is there by adjacency list, adjacency matrix, and adjacency set. But adjacency set is not in our GATE syllabus. Okay, it's not in our GATE syllabus because union and that find is there, disjoint set, it is not in our GATE syllabus. Okay, disjoint set is not in our GATE syllabus. So this is the matrix that they have given. Okay, this is the matrix that they have given. Now from A you can connect to A, means from 1 if you want to go to 1, cost is 0. From 1 if you want to go to 2, cost is 10. If you want to go from 1 to 3, the cost is 30. Like this way. See, there are two ways to construct this one. One, what you can do if you are getting confused, you constructed the graph from here. You constructed the graph from here. So from 1 to 2 if you want to go, the cost is 10. From 1 to 3 if you want to go, the cost is 30. 2 to 1 10, 2 to 3 is 20, 3 to 1 is your 33. So you have constructed a graph. 30 is the weight. Okay, you people are saying that 30. Okay, let me take. So in this way you have constructed. Now you will choose the node which is having the list 1, 2 you have chosen. Now from this you can go, because next is this. So 30 is the answer. Yeah, this is the small one, directly you can construct it. But if it will be big graph, then to construct a graph, then from there to minimum spanning tree, it will take time. So we are having a shortcut. What the shortcut? Now I will solve by using the shortcut. Always we are going to have a same answer only. See, for I have told you that for a graph you can have a more than one spanning tree. Always the cost is going to be same. Okay, always the cost is going to be same. Now see what you can do. You are choosing from node 1. Now from 1 if you will connect the node, you can connect to node 2 and 3. So which node you should choose? You should choose the node 2. See, now I'm not constructing a graph, this is another way. From 1 I can connect to node 2 which is going to have a list weight, because from 1 I can go to node 2 which is having a list we have connected to. So I have chosen these two nodes. Now from these two nodes I have chosen this. Now from 1 to 2 just see in these values which is having a list weight 20, which is having list weight 20. Now from 2 you connect 3, you know, you connect 3. Now means you have chosen again 3. So if it's having, say this way also, we can, I have not constructed a graph, from the weighted matrix only I have chosen. First I have started from 1, I have seen that from 1 I can connect to the nodes, and which node is having a least weight? So node 2 is having a least weight 10. From 1 I have connected to 10. Now I am having 1 and 2 in the graph. I am having 1 and 2 in the tree. Sorry, 1 and 2 in the tree. Now through 1 and 2, in which node I can go which is going to have a least weight? If I go to the node 3 which is going to have a least weight, that is 20. So I am connecting from 2 to 3 is having 20. Now in this way only we will connect. Now we will take another example and we are going to see this implementation only. Okay. Now see the next one. So your next example is, I am giving you weighted matrix. Okay, weighted matrix. It's having 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so its weight is having here 0, 10, 10, 50, 10, 0, 40, 30, 10, 40, 0, 20, 50, 30, 20, 0. Now see. Now I'm starting. Now I'm starting from the node 1. Okay, node 1. Now from node 1, you can connect to node 2, 3, and 4, which is having a least weight 2 and 3. So you can connect anyone. So I'm first choosing 2. one two. Now I have chosen one. I have chosen one two. From one I have connected two. Wait, 10. So now I am having a in the tree which nodes 1 and 2. Now between 1 and 2, see 1, 2 I have connected, that is 2, 1. You just make a circle so that you will not again take that node. Okay, again you are not going to take that. Now from this remaining, all this 4 and 4 here, 8, wait, which is the less this 1, 2, 3. You connect 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Wait, 10. Now in the tree you are having 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Now from means you have chosen 1, 3, that is 3, 1 you have chosen. Now which is having a least weight? Now here it's having a 20, see. Here 50, 30, 40, here it's having a 20. So you connect 3 and 4, you connect 3 and 4, which is having a weight 20. So 3 to 4 I have connected, weight 20. Now you have even connected 4. So you have connected all the nodes, 4 nodes, you require 3 edges. So minimum cost is your, 20 plus 10 plus 10 is your 40. Please let me know whether it is clear or not. See, if anyone having any doubt, please ask. Clear hai na sabhi ko? Kisi ko doubt hai to puch lijiye. Again one gate question. Now we are going to take again one gate question. See, that is asked in your gate. In gate, it is a one of the important question. It is asked in your gate 2010 only. Okay. Now they are saying that construct the spanning tree. So this is the last question only for today's session. Okay. And this is the action you get 2010. Construct the spanning tree, but it is a very important question. Please pay attention here. Construct the spanning tree from the given cost matrix such that zero is a node which is a leaf. When we can say that a node is a leaf? When it is not having any child, but it will have a parent. Okay, but it will have a parent. Now 0, 1, 2, 3. So 0, 1, 2, 3. 0, 1. 8 1 4 1 0 12 4 9 8 12 0 7 3 1. You try. If you want to try, you can try. So your time start now, you can try, and in comment you can tell me what is going to your minimum cost. Construct the minimum cost spanning tree from the given cost matrix such that zero is leaf. Here now I'm starting. Okay, and here in the question they are saying that construct the minimum cost spanning tree from the given cost matrix such that zero is leaf. Okay, zero is a leaf. Okay, from this zero, node zero. Okay, now from node zero you can connect to 1 2 3 4, any node you can connect, but which is having a least weight? 1 and 3. So you can connect either 1 or 3. I am choosing 1. So you are choosing 1. I have chosen 1. Yahan minimum cost spanning tree hum nahi bol rahe nikal, yahan bol rahe here the question is not saying to find the minimum cost spanning tree. Here the question they are saying that to find the minimum cost spanning tree when zero is a leaf. Zero leaf hona chahiye. Zero should be a leaf. So if zero is a leaf, then it should connect to only one vertices. Only one vertices. From zero you have connected to one. Age is one. Okay, means you have chosen zero and one. And you have connected this 1 to 0. Now from 0 and 1, if you will choose these two vertices, 0 and 1, which is having a least weight, these three. From 0 you can connect to 3, which is having a least weight, but you will not connect that from 0 to 3. Why? Because if you will connect 0 to 3, then it is not going to a 0 is not going to a leaf, because a leaf is a node which is not having any child. So 1 is the parent of 0, but it is not going to have any child. So that's why you should not choose that. You should not choose. So either you can choose 0 to 1 or 0 to 3. Only one you can choose. Okay, only one you can choose, because they have said in the question that 0 is a leaf. That 0 is a leaf. So that is, that you should not consider. If you will consider that, then only you are going to get a minimum cost tree as 7. Okay. So now from 0 and 1, you are not going to consider 0. You are not going to again consider 0. You are not going to connect any other node from 0 now. So you are having only node which is 1. Now the node which is adjacent to 1, which is having a least weight, is 3, because here is 4. So you connect from 1 to 3, which is having a least weight 4. Now you are having 0, 1 and 3 in the tree. So you have connected 0, 1 to 3, 1 to 3, 4. So 3 to 1, 4. This edge you have connected. That's why I am making a circle. Okay. Now you are having it in the tree, you are having 0, 1, 3, but 0 you are not going to consider anymore because it's a leaf. Now from 1 and 3, which next node you can choose? You can choose 4, because here weight is 2. Because from 1 in this row and this row, which is having a least weight? 2. So from 3 you can connect to 4, which is having a least weight 2. So you have again added 4 also. So means from 3 to 4, means 4 to this you have connected. Okay, so you are having a 5 vertices. So you require, so which node is remaining? 2. 2 you have not connected. You have connected 0, 1, 3, 4. Only you require to connect 2. Now you can connect to 2 from 1, 3 and 4. But if you connect from 4, it will take the least weight 3. See, in this row if you choose, it is having a least weight 3. So from 4 you can connect to 2, which is going to have a So 3 to 4 is your 3 to 4. 3 to 4 is your 2. Now see, it's 5. It's 5 and 5, 10. Minimum cost is your. This is a very good question, because 0 is a leaf. So in this way you have constructed. This kind of tree is called as line tree. Line graph or line tree. Okay. Because it is going in a line wise line. So another spanning tree also you can go. Someone's that I got like this way. Someone might have constructed in the way first they have connected from 0 to 3. So let me draw that one. So if you have done that, I'm erasing that one. Okay. So because otherwise I need to go to the previous slide, next slide. So I'm erasing that. Okay. Now another minimum cost spanning tree that you can get. So if someone has drawn that one, you can verify your answer. Hope it is clear. Okay. So I'm erasing that one. So from 0 to 1, then 1 to 3, then 3 to 4, then 4 to 3. Okay, you are getting a minimum cost here 7, 10. Minimum cost here you are getting at 10. Now I am choosing another minimum cost that we can get from 0. From 0 you can connect to 3. Yeah, you can connect. So now you are connecting 0 to 3. Cost is your 1. From 0 to 3 you are connecting. 0 you have connected and 3 you have connected. From 0 to 3 cost is 1. 3 to 0 cost 2, that you have connected. Now see the node, because 0 you are not again going to consider, because 0 is a leaf. Now you are not going to connect any other node to 0. So only node you are having in the tree is 3. Now from 3 you can connect to 4, which is having a weight 2. So you are connecting from 3, 4, which is having a weight 2. Now 4 you have added, 3 to 4, so this is 2. Now from 3 to 4, node 3 and 4, which node you can connect which is having least weight? So this 2, node 2, weight is 3. So from 4 you can connect to 2. From 4 you can connect to 2, which is having a weight 3. So from 4 you have connected 2, which is having a, so this you have chosen 4 to 2. Now only one node is remaining, that is 1. Node 1 is remaining. So here the minimum weight is 4. So through which? Node 3. So from node 3, if you will go to node 1, it is going to have incur cost 4. 3, 2, 4, cost 4. Cost how much? 4. Sorry, it is 1. It is 1. It is equal. Okay. So, 3, 2, 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1, cost 4. So, 1, 2, 3, cost. Now, minimum cost you see, it's your 5 and it's your 5. 5 plus 5 is your 10. So, 2 minimum cost you are getting, and always you are getting a minimum. So, always the cost is going to your same. Always the amount that is going to incur is going to your same. Okay, always it is going to same. So, this is your minimum cost spanning tree for the given. Am I clear? Please let me know whether it is clear or not. Anyone is still having any doubt, then you can ask me. Anyone is still having any doubt, then you can ask me. See, this is not a actual minimum cost spanning tree. It is not a minimum cost spanning tree. It is the minimum cost spanning tree when 0 is a leaf. When 0 is a leaf. When 0 is a leaf. When you will not consider 0 as a leaf, then we will get something else. Okay, something else. Yeah, welcome, bank. So, is it clear now? So now, if you are done with the writing, now I will construct a spanning tree for that. Now we will construct a spanning tree, not considering 0 as a leaf. Now I am going to construct a spanning tree. Now see the spanning tree. Now I am going to construct a spanning minimum spanning tree, not considering 0 as a leaf. Now I will not consider this. Now see, the minimum cost spanning tree is going to be different. The two that we have got is the minimum cost spanning tree when 0 is the leaf. Now we will construct a spanning tree. From 0 you can connect to 1. Yeah, from 0 you are connecting 1. Which is having 1. Wait. So 0, 1 you have connected. Now from 0 you can even connect to 3. Because now 0, I am not saying. Now I am not saying that 0 is a leaf. Now I am not saying. Now I am not saying. Okay. Now remove the question. Such that 0 is, I am removing this. Now it is not a gate question. So you have to construct the minimum cost spanning tree from the given cost matrix. Now this is the question. Now answer will be different. Now you are going to get a minimum cost spanning tree. Okay. That was the minimum cost spanning tree when 0 is a leaf. Now from 0 you can even connect node 3. And you will get 1. So 0, 3, 3, 1. 0, 3. So 3, 0 is 1. So you have connected 3. Now from 0, 1, 3, which node you should connect? You should connect 2. That node 4, weight 2. So from 3 to 4, you should connect weight 2. So 3 to 4. So 4 you have connected, weight 2. Now you are only remaining is node 2. Node 2 you can connect from 4. 4, node 2. From 4, 2 to 4. So you have connected from 4 to 2, node 3. So this is your 1, 1, 2, 2 plus 4 and 3, 7. So now you are going to get minimum cost as 7. So this is the actual minimum cost for this graph when I am not considering 0 as a yeah, correct master. So hope it is clear to everyone. Now if you are having any doubt, you can ask me. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Please let me know whether it is clear or not. So if you are watching for the first time, please subscribe this channel and press the bell icon and like this session. Spanning tree, pata karna hai. First step one is first connect the two nodes with minimum weight. So you connect the two nodes with minimum weight. Okay, first connect the two nodes with minimum. And anyone, if you are having any general doubt, any query, if you are having, you please comment. I will take your doubts now. So first connect the two nodes with minimum weight. Connect the two nodes with minimum weight. Then from the two nodes, connect the nodes with least weight. Now from these two nodes, connect the nodes with least weight and so on. We'll keep on doing. Okay. So just like if you are having this graph, which two node we should connect, which is having a least weight. So I'm connecting 1 and 6, which is having a least weight. First I have connected 1, 6. Now from 1 I can connect to 2 and from 6 I can connect 5. But I will connect the node which is going to have incur least weight. So from 6 you can connect to 5, which is going to incur 25. That's why from 6 I have connected 5, which is incur 25. Okay. From same, now from 1, 6, 5 I can connect to which node? I can go to 2, I can go to 7, I can go to 4, but it should incur least weight. So from 5 I am connecting 4, which is incurring cost 22. Similarly, from 4 I am connecting 3 because it's incurring less cost. So from 3 I am connecting 2, which is incurring less cost, and from 2 I am connecting 7, which is incurring. See, 7 I can connect from 5 also, from 4 also, but I am connecting from the nodes which will incur less cost, which will incur less cost. Is it clear, Mayank? Please let me know. So whenever you are connecting any two nodes, after that you see the adjacent nodes and you connect the next node which is going to incur less cost, least cost. Okay, less or least cost. So in same way you have to construct and you will get the minimum cost here 19. This I have not calculated, the student have given me the data. Is it fine, Mayank? So in this way I have taken the examples. Okay, in this way I have taken the examples and we have constructed. Okay, for beginner it is a difficult question because 2 month strategy plan and for beginner. Question is 2 month strategy plan for beginners. What should be the strategy plan? Algorithm C is covering. So you keep on doing algorithm, and in 2 month you try to see. You try to see cover like that one. Whether you try to complete maths and then aptitude also, because maths and apt is going to cover 30. And then algorithm, and aptitude, yeah, correct. What you can do, you just leave 1 to 2 week according to your means strategy, means whichever you feel, 1 to 2 week for revision, and you don't do revision now. You should not leave apt and maths because that is going to be the most weighted subject. Algorithm you are doing, then you should also do CDS algo. This is the, and if any things you have completed, if anything you have just like if you have studied OAS, DBMS or any of the subject, then you should revise it. Okay, is it clear, Kaveri? Or if any you just give me some data that you have completed that, or I require more data. Like to give a, if anyone wants any guidance from me, you should provide me a more data for you that you have completed this subject and this subject that is remaining. Okay, and you should also do previous year gate question. I will not advise you to give test series. I will not advise you, those who are preparing for 2 months only, OS DS completed sir. Achha. Operating system. So data structure, if you have completed, then you should also study C programming. Okay, and algorithm is going in the way, maths, apt, OAS revise. Okay, OAS you do the revision if you have completed, and you do just previous year gate question. You don't take test series. I will not advise, if you are preparing for 2 months, if you are a beginner for 2 months, 2 months strategy plan for beginners. Okay, so I will not advise you to take the test series. You should first try to complete the syllabus. Along with previous year gate question. And before 1 or 2 week, you just try to familiar with the environment. You take a free mock test that is available on the gate platform. If you'll go to the gate official website, they are having a free mock test, and there you will see the last year question paper. So you just see the instruction. What are the instruction you will get, so that you will feel the comfortable in the exam center. You should feel the same environment. Okay, you should not think that it's a new environment. So just to familiar with the environment, you should give the test series 1-2 mock test, full mock test you give, and just this mock test you are just giving not to improve your grant. This mock test you are giving just to get familiar with the environment because your syllabus is not complete. Okay, so you should try to complete the syllabus and do the previous year gate question. Then you do at least 1-2 mock test just to get familiar with your environment. And then you go to the and leave 1 or 2 week for the revision. Okay, see, if you will do this way, you are not going to get a, see, there is a very less chance that one should get a rank 1 or rank 2 or above 60, but you will get a decent rank. You will get a decent rank. And if you are getting a decent rank also, then also it's going to be useful. And even it will give you a confidence. Okay, this is a competitive exam. It's not like your college exam. So it's going to matter. Even 40 marks, 50 marks is going to matter in GATE. Okay. Himansu doubt. Himansu is saying DVMS OS C POC Algo Data Structure Maths. Currently I am going. Is there any way? So DVMS OS C and POC. You have completed, fine. You have completed this part. This weightage is 8, C weightage 4, TOC weightage is 8 to 10. Algo, DS and math, it's going on. So your preparation in a good way. You are in a good track. Okay. So you should also, so before 1 month, what I will suggest you, before 1 month, you should also do the aptitude. Not, I'm not suggesting you to do in December. I'm suggesting you to do in January. Till December, you try to finish the remaining subject. OS, you try to finish. DS, maths. Okay, try to finish it. And if you want to take any new subject, you take it. Like compiler design, you can take. It's easy subject. COA, you can leave. COA, you can leave. And computer network, if you are leaving, it's fine. So COA you can leave because I don't think that you will get that much time. See, I am saying according to your strategy, means according to your condition present. Okay. Or if you are preparing, if someone is preparing for 21, 22, 22 or 23. Okay. Then I will not say to leave any subject, but till December, I will suggest you to complete as much subject as you can, as much you can. Okay. Then do previous year GATE questions. And in January, you do revision and do previous year GATE question and do the case series in January. January, you leave only for revision. December, you do try to complete the syllabus as much as possible. In January, do revision, case series. Okay. Case series. Yeah. Thanks, Mike. Anyone is still having any doubt? You can ask me. Kisi ka koi aur doubt hai to puch sakte. And please try to share all the links, and in the description, the Telegram group is there. You can join there. In the description, Telegram group is there. Anyone is still having any doubt, any query they want to know, they can ask me. Okay. So first we are going to see implementation of a Prim's algorithm without Minip. Okay. Without Minip. The code I will show you, but first let me explain you how we will perform. Okay. Let me take an example. With example, I will try to first explain you the code. Okay. So Prim's algorithm implementation. Prim's algorithm implementation. Implementation. Prim's algorithm implementation without Minip. Okay. So you are not going to have a Minip. See, in Prim's algorithm, we are seeing that always we are trying to, first we are trying to take the age which is having a least weight. First I will take that. Okay. Then from that two nodes, we are going to find the adjacent node which is having a least weight. Okay. We will select the node which is having a least weight. So if you are having a, like if your tree is like this, 1, 6. 5 here, 7, 2, 3, 4. Let me see. If you are having like this, it is having a weight 10, it is having a weight 25, it is having a weight 24, it is having a weight 14, it is having a weight 28, it is having a weight 16, it is having a weight 12, 18. And 22. Okay. Now, this is the graph they have given you. Now they are asking you the Prim's algorithm. So what we will do, we will take some and one array. Okay, one array I will take. See, before showing you the code how we will perform, I am just showing that. Okay, I will do one, I will take one array, okay, whose size will be 2 into n number of nodes. 2 into number of nodes, n minus 1, it should be n minus 1, because we will require. See, why I am taking 2n minus 1, let me explain first. See, to represent any age, we require 2 nodes, like 1, 6. It's a 1, 6. To represent an age, we require 2 nodes, like 1, 6 is representing an age which having a weight 10, which is having a weight 10. Okay. So like this, here I will write the, this is an array, here I will write the first, the ages that we are selecting. Okay, first I am selecting, just if you will execute the code, if you will, how you will take the ages. So first you will take the age which is going to have a least weight. So you are going to take the age that is 1, 6, see here only 10, least weight here 12, 18, so least weight is 10. So first you are going to select the, this is mean cost. I will take one variable mean cost that will have the value of the mean cost. Okay, means it will calculate. So like currently mean cost is 10, then you will add, like by adding the weight of the edges, mean cost will have the sum of that. Like first you will have 10, you are having 10. So first vertex, that first edge that you have chosen is 1, 6. So you will represent here 1, 6. See, if you are having doubt, you can ask me. Okay, so here we are having a 2 column and n minus 1, because in a spanning tree, in a minimum cost spanning tree, if you are having n nodes, then you are going to have n minus 1 edges, and it will represent the n minus 1 edges. It will represent the n minus 1 edges the way you are choosing. So first you have chosen 1, 6. First you have chosen 1, 6, which is having a weight 10. Okay, is having a weight 10. Now you will have some, I will create one near. Okay, this is going to be another one array which will have, just like one. So you will write here all the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here you will write all the vertices. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 you have written. Now you have first chosen from 1, you have chosen 1 and 6. Now from, you will see, you will take the node 1 and you will find that which one is near to 1. Okay, see, let me explain once more. Here the first edge that you have chosen is 1, 6, 1, 6. Now you will find from this all the nodes which is near, which is either near to 6 or 1, means one, whether 1 is near to 1 or 6, between these two only, because first 1 is near to 1, cost is 0. Now tell me whether 2 is near to 1 and 6. 2 is near to 1 because cost is 28. So this is a array near which will let you know that the nodes which is near to which node, just like means 2 kiska near hai, whether it is near to 1 or 6. So 2 is near to 1, node 1, and cost that is going to have is 28. Okay, now 3 is near to which one, 1 or 6? It's not near to either 1 or 6, so it will take the 6. Okay, see, if whenever we are getting infinity, see, this is the code I have written. See, whenever you are comparing that cost of IL is smaller than cost of IK, then near of I is equal to L. Okay, if cost of L, KL I am assuming as 1, 6, as 1, 6. Okay, K I am assuming as 1 and L is I am assuming as 6. Okay, now every time I will compare that from the remaining, from all the nodes, which node is near to 1 or which node is near to 6. And if you will see that cost of, like cost of here, see here, like cost of 3 to 1 is infinity. 3 to 1 is infinity. Cost of 3 to 1 is infinity, and cost of 3 to 6 is also infinity. whenever you are going to have a direct edge, then only it is going to have some cost. Otherwise, it will have the cost of infinity. So whenever you will have the infinity, you take the next one, that is L1, that is 6. Okay. So whenever, see, just like 1 and 6 is there, na, you are taking this one. Whenever infinity will come in both the case, you will take 6, means the next one. This is your K, this is your L, means you are going to take L. Please let me know whether it is clear or not. देखिए थोड़ा इसमें ध्यान देना पड़ेगा. इन दिस एल्गोरिथम यू हैव टू पे अटेंशन बिकॉज इट रिक्वायर्स सम अटेंशन, नॉट दैट मच इजी. ओके, इम्प्लीमेंटेशन उतना आसान नहीं है, थोड़ा आपको ध्यान देना पड़ेगा. अगर कहीं पे डाउट हो तो आप बोलिएगा. ठीक है, नाउ सो 3 to 6 इज इन्फिनिटी. नाउ 4, नाउ नोट 4, वेदर इट इज नियर टू 1 or 6. सो 4 इज नादर नियर टू 6 nor 1. So I will try it here. So 4 to 6 you have written infinity. See, we are seeing Prim's algorithm implementation without meaning. So if this is your graph, you need to construct a minimum cost spanning tree. Okay, now this is the implementation. I have written the code, but before explaining the code, this is a 2-page code. Okay, this is a little bit big code, and see, this implementation is required because after your gate, or whenever you are when you will go for MTech, you require a very good coding. Okay, very good coding you require, so you should know how to do the implementation. Okay, so before explaining that this code directly, I am first explaining by taking a graph and then how this code will execute. Okay, because then it will be easy to understand the code. So the code, what they are doing, it is having a two array. One array is having a size 2, let's assume it is T, array T having size 2 and n minus 1. Means column is 2 and number of rows is n minus 1. N minus 1, why n minus 1? Because if you are having n node, then in a spanning tree, how many edges you will have? N minus 1 edges. If you are having n node, then you will have n minus 1 edges. Okay. So you are having, so for that you require a, this will say that first we have chosen this edge, then next edge, then this. So Prim's algorithm say first take the edge which is having a minimum cost. So you have taken 1 and 6, which is having a minimum cost. Now from the all the nodes, create an array near. You will have a near which will let you know near is having a size n, number of vertices, which will know that whether 1 is near to 1 or 2 is near to which vertex, 3 is near to which vertex, 4 is near to which vertex, 5 is near to which vertex, which is present in your minimum spanning tree, you will choose. So 5 is near to which, whether it is near to 1 or 6. See here, 5 is near to 6 because 5 to 6 cost is 25 and 5 to 1 cost is infinity. See, if you are having a direct edge, then only it's going to have a cost. If it is having a multiple edges to reach 1, then it will have infinity. So 5 is near to 6 and its cost is, and its cost is 25, and its cost is 25. Now 6. 6 is near to whether 1 or 6. It's near to 6 only. 6 is on 6 only. Na? So it will be 6 and cost is 0. Now 7. Now 7 is near to 1 or 6. Both from 7 to 1 is infinity. 7 to 6 is infinity. So whenever both the cost is going to be infinity, you take the next one. L1. This is your K. This is your L. Okay. So 6 you are going to take. Okay. Now this you have, so this is the step 1. So first you have created one array of size this, and this is a near array which will tell you that which is near to which vertex. Okay, means 2 is near to which, 3 is near to which vertex. Okay, so by the way we will add it, this near vertex will change. Okay, so 7 to 6 cost is infinity. Okay, clear hai ki nahi bataiye, kisi ko doubt hai to boliega. Is it clear to all of you? Please let me know whether it is clear or not. It is little bit difficult, but it will take some time. It will be clear. Clear ho jayega, thoda time lagega. See, your next step. From this near, you choose the vertex. Choose the vertex which is having a minimum cost. See, if you will connect from 1 to, so from here you can see, you are going to take the adjacent node. 1 adjacent is 2 and 6 adjacent is 5. So the way we will choose 25, this node 5, because its cost is 25. Okay, and its cost is 28. So where we can get this data? We will get from this near. We will see that which is having a minimum cost. Here is 28, here is 25. So it means that I will connect the node 5. I will connect the node 5 through 6. See, in that way only we were doing. So now the cost is going to, you are going to add 25. Okay. Now see, the node which you have chosen, you have to make its cost 0. Just like 1 you have chosen, 6 you have chosen, and 5 also you have chosen. So you have to make the near as 0. The node which you have added in the spanning tree, you have to make this as 0. Okay, you will make this as 0. You have added, so near of this is going to be 0 because you have already added. So you have added the node 1, 5, 6. Now since you have added the 5, now you will choose that the remaining 1, 3, 4, 5. If I'll go from 5, means whether 4 is near to 5, because previously 4 is near to 6 and its cost is infinity. But now if I'll go 4 by using 5, its cost is 22. So then the way we will going to add the node one by one, we will see whether its near is going to change or not. Okay, means now you have added in the minimum spanning tree 5. Now check to the all the nodes except the nodes which you have chosen. This 1, 5, 6 you have already chosen. Now see whether 2 is near to 1 or the new node that you have added. So new node that you have added is 5. So 2 to 1 cost is your 28 and 2 to 5 cost is your infinity. 2 to 5 cost is your infinity. So 2 near is 1. So 2 near is not going to change. Now 3 near is 6. 3 near is 6, which is infinity. And 3 to 5 is also infinity. So 3 near is also not going to change. Now 4. 4 previously by use we are having in the tree only 1 and 6. So 4 near was having only 6. 6. 6. And cost was infinity. But now since we are having a node 5. Yeah, Chandra. We will cover the full syllabus. So if we go from 4 to 5. 4 to 5. The cost is going to 22. So now the near of 4 is going to change. Because previously its cost was infinity. So now we should go. The 4 near is going to your 5. 4 near is going to your 5. Which is going to have a cost 22. Now 7 we will check. Now 7 near, it's previously it's saying that 6. 7, 6 cost is infinity. Now we will check whether 7 is near to 5. 7 is near to 5 because its cost is 24. So cost 24 is smaller than infinity. So now this will also get changed. This will also get changed. So cost of, so 7 near is now, 7 near is now 5. Cost is 24. Now this work is done. You have find the near. Okay, by adding every node you will see that by adding that node whether its near is going to change or not. Okay, near vertex. Now between all these node you will choose the node which is having a least weight. Which node is having a least weight means between node 2 and its near, between node 4 and its near. So 22 is the least weight. Means if you'll now you should add the next node which is 4. So 4 we will add from node 5. 4 we will add from node 5. See, this way we are practically, means the implementation is like the same way we are doing. Okay, so first I have chosen 1, 6, then I have chosen 5, 6. Now I am choosing 4, 5. 4, 5. Vertex 4, 5. So 4 I have chosen now. Its cost is going to your 22. So since I have chosen node 4, you will make the near of 4 is 0. Because you have already chosen and you have to make the near of that node is 0. Near of that node is 0. Now again, after adding a new node that is 4, it may happen that the cost of the near of 2, 3 and 7 may change. So previously 2 near was 1. Previously 2 near was 1. Now I have added the node 4. So 2 is near to 4. No. So it will be as it is. Now 3 near was 6. 3 near was 6 previously. Now by adding node 4, yes, 3 near is going to change. Because 3 is now near to 4, which is having a cost 12. So 3 is now near to 4. 3 is now near to 4. 4, which is having a cost 12. Okay. Now 7. 7 near was previously 5. Now by adding 4, its near is going to change. Because previously, if you will go to 7 through 5, you will have the cost, you will incur the cost 24. But if you will go with the node 4, you will incur the cost 18. So its near is going to change. And now its near is going to your 4. 4, which is going to incur the cost 80. Now you have updated the near array. Now after that, again you will choose the node which is going to have a least weight. So 3, if you'll add 3 through 4, you will going to incur the cost 12. So now you will add 3, which is going to have weight 12. And since you have added node 3, you will make the near of node 3 as 0. Near of node 3. The way I am doing, so you have added 3, 4. Here you will write 3, 4. So this array is saying that this you have added first, then this you have added. Okay. This is showing the sequence of the order of the edges that you have added. Okay. So after adding, you make this as 0. Now again, now what we will do? We will see by adding 3 is near of 2 and 7 is going to change. So 2 near previously was 28. Now 2 to 3 is having a cost 16. 2 to 1 is having a cost 18. So previously we are going to 2 by using 1 and its cost was 28. But if I'll go now to 2 by using 3, cost is going to 16. So by after adding always the node, we are going to check whether its near is going to change or not. So yes, its near is going, 2 near is now going to change. 2 near is now 3, which is going to have a cost 16. Now 7 previously near was 4, which is having a cost 18. And now if you'll go from to 7, you will reach 7 by 3, it will cost incur. So it will be as it is, because 7 near is now 4 only. Now again, you will see this near and you will choose the node which is having a least weight. So if you will go to node 2 by 3, you will going to have a least weight, that is 16. So now you are adding age 2, 3. Age. And 2 you have added. 2 you have added and cost is going to your 16. Cost is going to your 16. And you will going to make this, since the node which you will add, you will make the near of that as 0. Now by adding 2, whether the near of 7 is going to change. So 7 near was previously 4, cost was 14. Now if we will go to 7 through 2, its cost is 14. Yes, so it will change because it is smaller. So I will write here 2, we'll write here 2, and its cost is going to your 14. So next node we are going to add is 7, and this is having it. So I have added the next node is 7 too. So how many edges? It's having 7 nodes, so 6 edges. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 I have added. Okay, and now I will make it. Please let me know whether it is clear or not. Sabko clear hai kya? Hindi mein explain karna hai to bata dijiye. Sabko clear hai to bol dijiye. In this way you will add all the cost of all the edges. You will get the minimum cost. So this way we will going to do the implementation of the Prim's algorithm without minif. So we are not having a minif here, because you are always choosing the edge weight which is minimum. Okay, so without having min heap also we have implemented. Please let me know whether it is clear or not. Now see the code. I think that it is clear to everyone. Now see the Prim's algorithm implementation without minif. So it is your algorithm Prim's. Okay, take it. हमें करना क्या है यहाँ पे, आपको ग्राफ दिया रहेगा, यहाँ पे आपको क्या करना है, मिनिमम स्पैनिंग ट्री बनाना है, मिनिमम स्पैनिंग ट्री। तो हमने कोड करने से पहले, हमने कोड में जो काम किए हैं वो मैं आपको एक्सप्लेन कर रहा हूँ ताकि आपको कोड समझने में दिक्कत ना हो। तो कोड में मैंने क्या किया, एक एरे ली है टी जिसका डायमेंशन है 2 × (n-1). 2 मैं यहाँ पे क्यों लिया हूँ, क्योंकि कोई भी एज को ये बताएगा ना कि आप किस सिक्वेंस में आप एज को ले रहे हैं। तो पहले आप जिस एज को ले रहे हो, तो एज किसी एज को रिप्रेजेंट करने के लिए आपको दो वर्टिसेस लगता है। जैसे आपने 1, 6 को इस एज को रिप्रेजेंट करना है, तो आप कैसे रिप्रेजेंट करेंगे 1, 6। ओके, तो अगर आपके पास n नोड्स होगा तो आपको (n-1) एजेस लगेंगे, इसलिए मैंने ये किया। अब मैं एक एरे ले रहा हूँ जिसका नाम है नियर। अब मैं एक एरे ले रहा हूँ, मैं एक फटाफट इसके जल्दी हिंदी में बता देता हूँ, ठीक है, फटाफट मैं बता देता हूँ इसको। देखिए एक बार और बता देते हैं, अच्छे से समझ में आ जाएगा। इंग्लिश में मैं बता दिया हूं, हिंदी में भी बता देता हूं, ठीक है। अब देखिए मैंने यहाँ पे क्या किया, इसी तरह आप लोग पूछ लिया कीजिए, मैं बता दूंगा, ठीक है। अब देखिए आपको करना क्या है, आपको हमेशा, आप एक चीज जानते हैं कि हम प्रिम्स एल्गोरिथम में क्या करते हैं,
हम नोड को ऐड करते हैं, किस नोड को ऐड करते हैं, नेक्स्ट नोड जो जिसका कॉस्ट उसके एडजेसेंट हो। जैसे पहले हम तो 16 को ऐड करेंगे क्योंकि इसका कॉस्ट सबसे कम है इस एज का, तो हम पहले 16 को ऐड करेंगे। ठीक है, 16 को ऐड कर दिए। अब हमें क्या करना रहता है, हम देखते हैं कि इसके एडजेसेंट कौन कौन सा नोड है, उसमें से एक जिसका वेट कम है। सो 1 से अगर 2 जाएंगे तो वेट 28 होगा, 1 से 5 जाएंगे तो वेट 25 होगा। तो हम 1 से 1 से नहीं ऐड करते 2 को, हम 6 से 5 को ऐड करते हैं क्योंकि वेट 25 होता है, कम होता है। तो उसी तरह हम करते हैं। तो इसके लिए हम क्या करेंगे ना, हम इसके लिए ये चीज पता करने के लिए कि कौन सा नोड नेक्स्ट ऐड करे उसका नियर कौन सा होगा, तो हम क्या करते हैं, हम एक एरे रखते हैं, हम एक एरे रखते हैं जिसका नाम ही हम नियर दे देते हैं, जिसका नाम ही हम नियर दे देते हैं। जैसे उसके इसमें सारे नोड्स रहता है, 1 2 3 4 5 6। ठीक है, अब देखिए जो नोड को आप सेलेक्ट कर पहले ले चुके हो आप उसको जीरो कर दीजिए। उसका नियर क्या होगा, 1 का नियर तो 0 ही है, 6 का नियर तो 0 ही है। आपको देखना है जैसे आप 1 और 6 को ऐड किए तो क्या 2 1 के नियर है कि 6 के नियर है, 3 क्या 1 के नियर है, जो आप ऐड किए हो उसी से सिर्फ आप देखोगे क्योंकि आप तो हमेशा इसमें ही ना दिखते हैं। ठीक है, तो क्योंकि इससे ही नोड जाएगा आपके स्पेनिंग ट्री में, तो अभी सिर्फ 1 और 6 ही है ना, तो 2 का नियर क्या है, 1 है कि 6 है, 2 का नियर 1 है। एंड कॉस्ट क्या इनकर कर रहा है, वो 28 कर रहा है। 3 का नियर क्या है, 3 का नियर क्या है, देखिए 3 का नियर कुछ नहीं है, 1 भी नहीं है 6 भी नहीं है। तो जब दोनों का डिस्टेंस इंफिनिटी होगा तो आप दूसरा वाला ले लीजिए, दूसरा वाला। ठीक है, तो 6 ले लीजिए आप, 1 भी ले सकते हैं कोई दिक्कत नहीं होगा। 4 का नियर क्या है, देखिए 4 का नियर 1 भी नहीं है 6 भी नहीं है, तो आप 6 ले लीजिए, कॉस्ट क्या हो गया इन्फिनिटी। 5 का नियर क्या है, देखिए 5 का नियर 6 है, कॉस्ट क्या है 25। अब देखिए जो ये इसका 1 और 6 का हमें नहीं करना है। ठीक है, क्यों, क्योंकि 1 और 6 हम ऐड कर चुके हैं। अब देखिए अब जो नोड आपको ऐड करना है जिसका मतलब नियर 0 नहीं है, वो क्या बता रहा है कि अब ये सब नोड्स को हमको ऐड करना है, इसमें से हम कौन सा नोड ऐड करें तो जिसका कॉस्ट कम होगा। मतलब अगर हम 5 को ऐड करेंगे 6 के थ्रू, 5 को ऐड करेंगे 6 से, तो उसका कॉस्ट कम होगा, 25 होगा। तो हम 5 को ऐड कर रहे हैं 6 से, इसका नोड 25। अब हमने नेक्स्ट नोड क्या चूज किया, 5 5 6। ठीक है, अब क्या करें, जैसे 5 को हमने तो ऐड कर दिए तो अब इसका हम नियर 0 कर देंगे, अब उसको नहीं करना। अब जैसे 5 को ऐड करने के बाद क्या 2 3 4 का नियर चेंज हो रहा है, क्योंकि वो देखना है हमें, क्योंकि पहले तो नियर 2 का 1 था, अब क्या 5 ऐड होने के बाद क्या उसका नियर चेंज हो रहा है कि नहीं, ये देखेंगे। तो पहले 2 का नियर 1 था, 5 ऐड करने से 5, देखिए 2 से 5 डिस्टेंस इन्फिनिटी है, तो उससे इसका नियर चेंज नहीं हो रहा है। यहाँ 3 है, ठीक है 3 है यहाँ, तो 3 से 6 कॉस्ट कितना है, देखिए 3 2 6 इन्फिनिटी है, 3 2 5 भी इन्फिनिटी है, तब भी नियर मतलब वही होगा। देखिए अब देखिए 4 2 6 आपका कॉस्ट कितना है, इन्फिनिटी है। अब 4, लेकिन 5 ऐड करने से 4 का नियर हो गया 5, 4 का नियर क्या हो गया 5, कॉस्ट क्या है 22। तो अब हम इसका नियर चेंज कर देंगे, तो 4 का नियर क्या हो गया 5 और कॉस्ट क्या हो गया, 4 का नियर हो गया 5 और कॉस्ट हो गया 22। ठीक है, अब देखिए आपके पास नोड क्या बचा है जिसको आप ऐड करने हैं, 2 3 4, 2 3 4 को आपको ऐड करना है। इसमें से जिसका कॉस्ट कम होगा उसको आप ऐड करेंगे। तो देखिए अगर 4 को आप ऐड करेंगे, किससे, ये बताता है ना कि आपके पास जैसे 1 6 5, ये क्या बताता है कि आप 4 को आप कैसे ऐड कर सकते हैं, इसमें से जो 4 को क्या 1 से ऐड कर सकते हैं, 6 से कि 5 से, जिसमें आपको कॉस्ट कम पड़ेगा, तो वो यहाँ पे बताता है नियर आपका, ये बताता है कि उसका नियर कौन सा है जिसका कॉस्ट कम है। तो 4 का नियर 5, अगर 4 को हम ऐड करेंगे नोट 5 से तो कॉस्ट कम पड़ेगा, 4 को हम ऐड कर दिए और उसका कॉस्ट कितना पड़ा 22। अब आप इसे ऐड कर दिए हो तो आप इसे 0 कर दीजिए, अब आप इसे 0 कर दीजिए। ठीक है, अब देखिए अब आप 4 को ऐड करने से कि 3 और 1 2 का नियर का चेंज हो रहा है क्या, अच्छा 7 को तो मैं लिखा नहीं, नोट 7 था, ये तो गड़बड़ हो गई। ठीक है, 7 का नियर क्या होगा, तब तक जैसे 4 और 5 में 7 का नियर 4 होगा। ठीक है, ये मैं देखा नहीं था कि हमारे पास 7 वर्टिसेस था, तो 7 का नियर 4 होगा। देखिए 1 6 5 4 में से 7 का नियर क्या है, 4 है, क्योंकि कॉस्ट यहाँ 18 है। ठीक है, तो 4 ऐड करने से क्या 3 का नियर चेंज होगा, 3 का नियर, हाँ 3 का नियर अब 4 हो जाएगा, क्योंकि पहले 6 था इन्फिनिटी, अब 3 का नियर 4 हो जाएगा, कॉस्ट हो जाएगा 12। देखिए क्लियर है, बताइएगा सबको क्लियर है कि नहीं, 3 का नियर क्या हो जाएगा 4, कॉस्ट हो जाएगा 12। अब उसी तरह 2 का नियर पहले 1 था, अभी 4 ऐड करने से नियर चेंज हो रहा है, नहीं, अब हम क्या ऐड करेंगे इस 1, 2, 3 एंड 7 से कौन सा नोड को ऐड करेंगे जिसका कॉस्ट कम है। तो अगर मैं 3 को ऐड करूं 4 के थ्रू से तो इसका कॉस्ट 12 हो जाएगा। तो अब मैं 3 ऐड करूं, बताइएगा समझ में आ रहा है, क्लियर है कि नहीं। एवरीवन प्लीज कमेंट, क्लियर है कि नहीं सभी को बता दीजिए। इसी तरह आपको करना है। अब क्या करना है, इसको अब जो ऐड कर दिए उसको जीरो कर दीजिए। अब 3 ऐड करने से जो बचे हुए हैं, जो बचा हुआ है उसको देखना है, ठीक है। देखिए तो 3 ऐड करने से क्या 1 का 2 का नियर चेंज हो रहा है। हाँ 2 का नियर चेंज हो रहा है, 2 का नियर चेंज हो रहा है, ठीक है। तो अब 2 का नियर क्या हो जाएगा, 2 का नियर अब हो जाएगा 3 और कॉस्ट हो जाएगा 16। 7 का नियर चेंज हो रहा है, 3 ऐड करने से नहीं हो रहा है। अब नेक्स्ट नोड हमें जो ऐड करेंगे वो होगा 2 और उसका कॉस्ट हो जाएगा 16। अब देखिए कोड समझने में, मैं पहले ये समझा दिया ना, तो अब कोड समझने में आपको आसानी होगी। तो ये आपका 0 हो गया, ये आपका 0 हो गया। अब देखिए 2 को ऐड करने से क्या 7 का नियर चेंज हो रहा है। हाँ 7, 7 का पहले नियर 4 था, कॉस्ट 18 था, लेकिन 2 ऐड करने से 7 का नियर हो गया 2 और कॉस्ट हो गया, 7 का नियर हो गया 2 और कॉस्ट हो गया 40। अब हम 7 को ऐड करेंगे इस तरह, हमें 2 बार मैं बता दिया हूँ। अब नाउ वी विल गो टू दी कोड, ओके। सो आई वी वेन एक्सप्लेन दी ट्री बाय यूजिंग इन हिंदी एज वेल एज इन इंग्लिश, ओके। सो नाउ दिस इज योर 4 5, नेक्स्ट वी हैव एडेड 4 5, देन वी हैव एडेड 3 4 एंड देन वी हैव एडेड 3 4 देन 2 3 देन 7 2। सो यू कैन ऐड ऑल दिस कॉस्ट एंड इट इज गोइंग टू योर मिनिमम कॉस्ट। सो मिनिमम कॉस्ट इज गोइंग टू योर 10 + 25 + 22 + 12 + 16 + 14, which is going to your something, you calculate it, okay? It is going to your minimum cost. Now see the implementation, okay? So here you require, so prims E is your, E is the set of edges, E is going to represent the set of edges. Cost is N into N weighted matrix, okay? It is going to represent the, what is going to be the weight, okay? What is going to be the weight? From one node to another means what is going, just like this here, just 1 to 6, what is the weight, say 10, so that is going to represent in cost, okay. And MST is computed and is stored in a array T. So MST we are going to compute, that is minimum spanning tree, and is stored in the array which is having a dimension from 1 to n minus 1, and it should be, okay, so it is representing the row, it will go 1 till n minus 1, and it is representing the column, it will go 1 and 2, okay. The way I have, so size is going to be n minus 1 and 2, okay. The number of row you are going to have is n minus 1, and column you are going to have 2. This is the size of the T. Now first word is, let ki be the edge of the minimum cost in E. So you, they have given you E, the minimum cost, the set of edges. Now from set of edges, find the edge which is going to have a minimum cost. Find the edge which is going to have a minimum cost. Like 10. See, to understand the code is little bit difficult, okay. So I need your attention here, what we are doing. So this was our graph. Okay, this was our graph. But now it will be easy for you people to understand, because you have already understood the way we are going to work in the work that we are going to do in the code, okay. So first is going to KL be an edge of minimum cost in E. So minimum cost is going to be 10, so KL is going to your 1 6, okay. This is your L, this is your L. Now minimum cost is going to your cost of KL, cost of KL is going to your 10. So first, now minimum cost is your 10, okay. Now see, for I equal to N, now you will see from I, this is representing the vertices. From I to N, cost of I, cost of node I to L, L is your 6, you are checking whether cost of 1 and 6, is it smaller than cost of 1 and ए इज योर मंथ सी मीन्स हेयर यू आर चेकिंग वेदर वेदर नोड वन इज इट नियर टू सिक्स और इज इट नियर टू वन. सो सी कॉस्ट ऑफ वन एंड वन इज जीरो सो इट इज नियर टू दिस दिस इज ग्रेटर एल्स पार्ट वी विल गो सो नियर ऑफ आई इज गोइंग टू दैट इज नियर ऑफ वन दैट इज नियर ऑफ वन इज गोइंग टू योर that is near of one is going to your one so this way we are going to do this way. Okay near of one is going to your one now similarly for node 2 so there it will be I will then increment to 2 I will be increment to 2 now you will check that 2 and l is your 6 whether cost 2 to 6 2 to 6 is your 2 to 6 is your infinity, and 2 to 1 is your 28. Is it greater? No, infinity is not greater than 28. So this condition is again going to be false. So else part again near of I is your k is your one. This one, this k is your one. So again near of 2 is going to your one. This way we are finding the near. We are always taking every nodes and we are comparing. Then again, I will be now 3, again 3, again now 3. Now with 3, we will check. The only once I am going to execute this, for rest of the iteration, I hope that you will get it, okay? Now we will check whether 3 to 6 cost is your, 3 to 6 cost is your infinity and 3 to 1 cost is your infinity. So infinity is smaller than infinity. False. So near of I is going to your k. That is your k is your one. Okay. Like this, it will work. Okay. So I think that 1 minute. 1 2 minimum cost 1 and 1 1 and 1 2 is your l. So okay. So in this way, it will find the near. Now we are going to, so after finding the near, see till this point, I hope that it is clear. The same way, the way I have find it the near, you have to find the near. Okay. Please let me know till this point whether it is clear or not. Now we will make near of k and l as 0 because we have already added that node. So near of l, I is going to your 0 and k l is going to 0. Once 6 I have added, then 0. Now see. Now you are going to add how many remaining edges you are going to have? N minus 1 edges you are going to from n equal to 2 to n minus 1. Because first edge you have already added. Till n minus 1 you are going to add the edges. So that's why I am now running the loop from 2 to n minus 1. Okay, from 2 to n minus 1. From 2 we are going to. Because now second edge, third edge, fourth edge till n minus 1. Now let j, so after doing it will be, see after finding this, the near will look like this. Okay, the near will look like this. Let me write. So it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, clear ho raha hai na ye cheeze. Thoda difficult hai, lekin main koshish kar raha hu ki aapko asani se samajh mein aaye. देखिए, so it is going to be 28, it is going to be infinity, it is going to be infinity, it is going to 25, it is going to be infinity. Now let j be an index such that near of j is not equal to 0. Why I am saying that near of j should not be equal to 0? If it is not equal to 0, so let j be an index such that near of j not equal to 0. Near of j not equal. Why near of j is not equal to 0? Because if near of j, just like near of 1 is equal to 0, it means we have already added that. Then why to consider again? We will check that near of j should not be equal to 0 and cost of j to near of j, just like cost of 2 to 1 is minimum. Means now you are choosing the next node. How you can choose the next node? You will choose the next node which near should not be 0 and whose cost should be minimum. Like 2 to 1 is cost is 28 and 5 to 6 is cost is 25. So you will choose, now j is going to your 5 because its near is not going to be 0 and its cost is going to be your 25. Okay. So now you are going to add 5 and 6. इन टी ऑफ, इन टी ऑफ टू वन यू आर गोइंग टू एड जे, जे इज योर फाइव, एंड टी ऑफ टू टू यू आर गोइंग टू एड नियर ऑफ जे, नियर ऑफ जे इज योर सिक्स. So in array T you are going to add 5, 6. 2 of 1 is 5 and 2 of 2 is your 6. So you are going to add, like first you have added, what? 1, 6, then you have added 5, 6. Now by checking, since you have added J, now mean cost is going to be mean cost whatever you have completed, calculated, then cost of J and near J. Okay, means this 5 and 6 is your 25, you will add 25 now. So mean cost is your, previously it was having 10 plus 25, and again you are making near of j is equal to 0. Why near of j we are making equal to 0? Because we have already added 5, okay. Now by adding 5 you will find the mean cost, means you will find the near by adding now 5, whether its near is going to be, whether the nodes like 2, 3, 4, 7 near is going to change or not. Again I am executing the loop for k equal to 1 to n. And I am checking that near of k should not be equal to 0. Near of k should not be equal to 0. Because if it is equal to 0 near of something, means you have already taken. You have already taken 5, 6. So you are not going to find the near of 1, 5 and 6. Now we will compare. So it is saying that previous cost of 2 and near of k, means cost of 2 and near of k is your 1. Its cost is 28. And you are going to check that previously its cost is 28, now by adding node 5, whether its cost is going to change or not, so now it will compare with cost k is going to your 2, and j is going to your 5. So by 2 to 5 you will check by adding 5 whether the near of 2 is going to change or not. Okay, we are going to compare. So 2 to I is your infinity and 2 to 5 is your 2 to 5 is your infinity. So it is false. Okay, so cost will be as it is. Near of 2 is going to be 1 only. Okay, because it is false. Okay, if these two conditions will be satisfied, like 4 is previously near to 6, but now 4 is near to 5. See, when k is equal to 4, how it will do? Like this way it will execute. Now k will be 4. So near of 4 is not equal to 0. Yes, and cost of 4 and near of 4 is your 6, which is infinity, and k is your 4 and j is your 5. Cost of 4 5 is your 24. It's greater. Means by adding node 5, the near of 4 is going to change. So near of 4 is going to your J, that is your 5. So that is your, like this. Okay. So again, after adding that node, you will check that which node's near is going to change, and you will update it. Now again, you will go and again you will see for J be an index such that near of J not equal to 0, and cost you will find. Again, you will execute till n minus 1. Till same way. Again, you will go and you will choose the node age which is going to have a least weight. So it will be here 24, like this. Please let me know whether it is clear or not. समझ में आया क्या सभी को? देखिए हमेशा आपने तो एक एज तो ऐड कर दिए, फिर n माइनस एज को आपको ऐड करना है. आप क्या करेंगे? आप देखेंगे कि जिसका कॉस्ट कम है उसको आप ऐड करेंगे. j भी कोई इंडेक्स होगा, जिसका j नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो होगा, कॉस्ट मिनिमम होगा. फिर जिसको पता कर लिए उसको फिर टी में डाल दीजिए, फिर मिनिमम कॉस्ट में ऐड कर दिए. अब जिसको ऐड कर लिए तो उसका तो नियर जीरो करना है ना, उसको जीरो कर दिए. फिर जो नोड को ऐड किए उसको ऐड करने से जो बाकी नोड है जिसको आपको ऐड करना है उसमें देखना है क्या उसका नियर चेंज हो रहा है कि नहीं. ठीक है, इसलिए जो पहले कॉस्ट ये है, पहले बता रहा है कि के और नियर के जो पहले कॉस्ट है. अब जे जो नया ऐड कर रहे हैं उससे अगर पुराना कॉस्ट अगर ज्यादा है तो नया कॉस्ट वाला जो नया एज नया नोड एज करने से कॉस्ट कम हो रहा है तो नया नियर क्या हो जाएगा? नियर के इज गोइंग टू बी योर जे. बोलिए क्लियर है कि नहीं? थोड़ा कॉम्प्लेक्स है, आप लोग थोड़ा ध्यान दीजिए, समझ में आ जाएगा. इंपॉर्टेंट है क्योंकि यहाँ पे टाइम कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी पूछा जाता है. मैंने पूरा एफर्ट किया हूं, अगर तब भी समझ में नहीं आया होगा तो प्लीज कहिए। इफ यू आर स्टिल नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड देन फील फ्री टू आस्क मी, आई कैन अगेन रिपीट। इट्स इंपॉर्टेंट कोड, यू विल गेट दिस काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस इन योर इंटरव्यू, दे विल आस्क यू टू राइट द कोड ऑफ द प्रिम्स एल्गोरिथम। सी दिस थिंग्स आर इंपॉर्टेंट इन योर इंटरव्यू, ओके। एंड वी नीड टू नो दिस कोड बिकॉज टू फाइंड द टाइम कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी ऑफ प्रिम्स एल्गोरिथम। थोड़ा कॉम्प्लेक्स है, देखिए सिर्फ इजी चीजें ही तो पढ़ा के नहीं जाना है ना, जो सब्जेक्ट आपके सिलेबस में, मुझे तो पढ़ाना ही होगा ना। बहुत सारे लोग कोड छोड़ देते हैं, ठीक है, प्लीज लेट मी नो वेदर इट इज क्लियर और नॉट, कमेंट कीजिएगा सब कोई, क्लियर है कि नहीं, इज इट क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू? Now take another example. You are having a node like here, you are having one. Can you summarize the code? Yeah, yeah, why not? See, first I am finding the an age which is having a minimum cost. Then I am adding that to minimum cost, and I'm that node, it is 1 to 1. I'm adding that age in the array. Okay, the same way. See, this is working this way. So let me take one more one. See, with this example it will be more clear. See, this example it will be more clear. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So you will have one array, so which size is going to be 2 to n minus 1, number of vertices, how many you are having, 5, so it will have n minus 1, 4, okay. So this is having a T, and you will have an array near, you will have an array near, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now the code is saying that let ki be an age of a minimum cost. So first you are going to select an age which is of minimum cost. So minimum cost is your this one. So you are going to select first 1 and 2, which is going to have a minimum cost 1, and you have chosen first 1 and 2. Now near, whether, now near, this is an array, you are going to find whether 1 is near to 1, means the node which you are having in the minimum spanning tree, you will find whether 1 is near to 1 or 2. 1 is near to 1, cost is 0. 2 is near to 2, cost is 0. Now 3 is whether near to 1 or 1. 3 is near to whether 1 or 2. So 3 is near to 1, which cost is 2. Now 4 is whether near to 2 or 1. So 4 is near to 2. See, between 1 and 2, you will choose whether 4 is near to 2 or 1. So 4 is near to 2. Whose cost is 3. Now 5 is near to 2 and cost is 5. Okay, see, this till this it is done by here. You have first added this in the T, that KL you have added. Now for I equal to N, you are comparing the cost with every node, whether is it small, okay, near to L or K. Okay, now you will execute, you will make near of K and L is going to be 0. Okay, near of K and L, that the node that you have added is you are going to make as 0. So you have added 1 and 2, and you are going to make that, because you have added that, you have added that, so you are going to make this as 0. Okay, near of this is going to make 0. Now for j equal to 2, the iteration for I equal to 2 to n minus 1, this loop is running till n minus 1, because you are going to add n minus 1 ages, and one age you have already added, that's why here I am starting from 2 to n minus. Now you will choose the let j be an index such that near of j should not be equal to 0, because if it's near of j, if near of 1 is equal to 0, means you have already added, so you are not going to select. So see, it's saying that let j be an index such that near of j should not be equal to 0, and cost of j and near of j should be minimum, because you will choose the node which cost is going to this, like here 3 is near 1 and its cost is minimum 2, because here 4 is near to 4 but cost is 3. So out of the remaining node, हुज कॉस्ट इज गोइंग टू योर मिनिमम. सो इफ यू विल गो टू द नोड वन नोड थ्री बाय वन इट्स कॉस्ट इज गोइंग. सो यू विल सेलेक्ट j equal to 3. So j is going to 3. So j been index such that near of j not equal to 0 and j cost of j and near of j is minimum. So now j is going to your 3. J is going to your 3. Okay. Now t of, now you will add t of I means t of 2 1 because I is now 2. That is 2 over 1. You will add that. So you have added 3 and 1. You have added 3 and 1. Okay. You have added cost of that 2 and 1 is your j and cost of 2 and 2 is your near of j. Near of j. Near of j is your 1. See. This you have added. Now, in mean cost, you will add that. In mean cost, you will add that. So, we will take at the last what is going to be the sum of mean cost. At last, we are going to. So, 1, 2 is going to your 1 and 1, 1, 2, 3. This I have added 3. It's going to be 1. Okay. Sorry, its cost is 2. Its cost is 2. Cost is 2. Okay. Now see. Now you have added mean cost is equal to cost of that. Now near of j you are going to make as 0. So near of j that is 3. Near of 3 is going to, because you have added 3, you have to make this as 0. I think that by this example it will be clear. Okay. Now since you have added 3, now you have to find that by adding 3, whether near of 4 or 5 is going to change or not. See here. Now what we are doing here, we will check. K we are going to execute from 1 to n. From 1 to n, we will check that near of k should not be 0. Then only, because if see, near of k should not be equal to 0, then only you are going to check whether it's, because if it is equal to 0, means you have already added. No need to count. Now, near cost of k and near of k should be, if it is greater than near of k and j, k is your 1 for every vertices you are choosing and j is your 3. Okay, see here. So, cost of, first is saying that cost of j and near of j, if it is greater than cost of j, sorry, it is k. K is running from I equal to 1 to n. Okay, it is k. K is just a variable indices. Okay, and now cost is going to your kj, k is your here, k. It will compare. See, this three, it will not compare because it's equal to 0. So cost of, so 4 is near to 2, or we will check now 4 whether it is near to 3 or not. So 4 is near to 3, its cost is now 4, but previously 4 was near to 2, its cost was 3. So 4 is not near to 3. See, because see here, cost of 4 and near 4, see, cost of k is your 4 and near of k is your 2, which is going to your 3. Is it greater than cost of 4 and new node 3? So 4 and new node 4, 3 is your 4, 2. It should be 4, 2, 3 and 4, 3. Yeah, 4, 3 is your 4. See. Is it 3 is greater than 4? No. Means previously only it is smaller. So if you will go to 4 by using 3, it is smaller. So you are not going to change the near of. Please let me know whether it is clear or not. Okay. So in this way, this code is doing is now by taking the new node that you have added j, it will compare from the remaining node whether its near is going to change or not. If its near is changing, it is assigning the new near. Okay. So now we will see. Now near of 4 is your 2 only because its cost is 2. Now near of 5, is it 3? No, because in 5, 2, 3 is your infinity. So it is near to 5, is near to 2 only, its cost is 5. Now you are going to add from this, between these two, again let j be some node where, see, again now execute, again I will be now 3, it will go, let j be an index such that near of j should not be equal to 0 and cost of j and near of j is minimum. So between these two, which cost is minimum? This. So now you will add 4. Now you will add 4, but through which node? From 2. Cost is good. Now you will make this as 0. And now by adding 4, whether its near is going to change or not. प्रीवियसली 5 वाज गोइंग टू वी आर रीचिंग 5 थ्रू 2 कॉस्ट इज 5 नाउ इफ विल गो फ्रॉम 4 कॉस्ट इज गोइंग टू बी 6 सो इट्स नियर विल रिमेन सेम 2 ओके इट्स रिमेन सेम नाउ अगेन द लूप विल रन एंड यू नाउ यू विल टेक द नोड 5 नोड 5 विल बी एडेड एंड कॉस्ट इज गोइंग टू योर सॉरी इट्स 5 कॉस्ट इज योर 5 We have taken two example to explain that. So first you have added 1, 2, then 1, 3, then you have added 4, 2, then you have added 5, 2. Now mean cost is going to your 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 1. Okay. So it's 5, 5, 10, 11. बताइए सबको क्लियर है ना अब तो मुझे लग रहा है कि क्लियर होगा सभी को प्लीज लेट मी नो वेदर इट इज क्लियर और नॉट नाउ सी हियर फर्स्ट एच इज हैविंग दिस पी एन एच दिस लाइन लेट के एल बी एन एच ऑफ मिनिमम कॉस्ट इन ई इन ए इन ई यू हैव टू फाइंड द एच व्हिच इज हैविंग ए मिनिमम कॉस्ट व्हाट इज इट इज गोइंग टू टेक द टाइम सो सिंस यू नो दैट यू आर हैविंग ई एजेस out of EH you have to find the minimum cost out of EH you have to find the minimum cost and it is going to incur time big of E because we have to examine all the edges out of all the edges you have to find the edge which is having a minimum cost AI is going to your minimum cost AI be an edge of minimum okay now mean cost you have added it is going to take constant time it is also going to take constant time okay now Now this loop is going to run for I equal to n, n times, and this is a constant one. So it is going to take big of n time. Going to take big of n. N is the number of vertices. N here is n is number of vertices. Okay, n is number of vertices. So till this, it has taken n. Now this is again going to take constant time, and this loop is going to run till n minus one. This loop is going to run n minus one. And inside that, whatever work it is doing, we will check. It is going to run till n minus 1 time. And you are finding from all the vertices, all the that from near, you will check all the boxes like this. Okay. And that j not equal to 2 and you will see the minimum. So all the nodes you are going to examine. So it is going to, this line is going to cost big of n. This line is going to incur big of n. This line is going to incur big of n. Okay. This line is going to. Now this is again a constant work. This is again a constant work. Okay. Now this loop is going to run till n time. This is again going to take big of n. So overall, this loop is going to run big of n. This is almost n times it is going to run. N so it is going to n square plus n square this is also this is going to be this inner loop is going to run n times our outer loop is going to run almost n times so this is going to run n square time and this is also going to run n square time. So time complexity here is going to your previously it is taking e big of e plus big of e plus big of n n is your number of vertices you can write v okay here it's going to your big of v square plus big of v square so it is going to your big of v square n is number of vertices that's why I have written so its time complexity without mean heap is going to your it's going to your v square please let me know whether it is clear or not time complexity clear hai ये लूप n माइनस वन टाइम्स चलेगा फिर हमें मिनिमम पता करना है तो मिनिमम जब हम पता करेंगे आउट ऑफ n जो आपका वर्टिसेस है यहाँ पे n n वर्टिसेस में कि किसका नियर ऑफ k नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो और कॉस्ट जीरो हो तो वो तो n टाइम्स लगेगा फिर अंदर लूप भी n टाइम्स रन कर रहा है तो n इंटू n स्क्वायर हो गया n क्या है नंबर ऑफ वर्टिसेस है वो वी स्क्वायर हो गया देखिए बताइए क्लियर है कि नहीं बताइए So its time complexity is going to be big of v square. Clear है सभी को? चलिए. कमेंट कर दीजिएगा। सो दिस वी हैव सीन द इंप्लीमेंटेशन बाय यूजिंग मीन हीप, सॉरी विदाउट यूजिंग मीन हीप। नाउ वी विल सी इंप्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ द प्रिम्स एल्गोरिदम बाय यूजिंग मीन हीप, बाय यूजिंग मीन हीप। सो प्रिम्स एल्गोरिदम now we are going to see prim's algorithm. See that code is easy, the implementation with mean heap, it is easy. So prim's algorithm implementation with mean heap is easy. Prim's algorithm implementation, so it's saying minimum spanning tree prim's. You write with me. This is a graph. It's a cost. I just simply note. Okay. So let me write what is. So G is a graph. G is a graph. cost matrix, it's a cost matrix. R is simply a note. it can be any note in a graph. Here it is not necessary to take the node which is having a list weight. Okay, so R is a node which is going to be any node. So here it is not necessary to take a node of list H. Okay, so G is a graph, cost is a cost matrix, R is a node, and it can be any node in a graph. Here it is not necessary to take a node of least H. Okay, now what we will do here, for each vertex U that belongs to graph vertices, vertices, u dot key is your cost is going to your infinity, and u dot pi is your nil, means the parent. Okay. u dot pi is your nil. Okay, so this we are using to represent that U is a vertex. And whose cost? Here what we will do. Here I will write every node. Here I will construct minimum mean heap. And initially I am initializing that every node parent is nil. Okay, means no parent. And its key means its cost is going to be infinity. Okay, its cost is infinity. Initially I am assuming. Okay, so if you are done with the writing, you let me know. Done with the writing, you please let me know. So for every vertex U that belongs to in the graph vertex, U dot key is going to infinity and U dot pi is going to nil. What am I saying then? Rator, is it done? Now R dot key we are making as D. So the node from where I will start, I am making its cost is 0. R dot key is 0. Okay, because we will make a mean heap, and mean heap is going to have the node first in the root as the which is having a minimum value. So I am making this as R dot key as 0 because I should start from there. Now Q, I am going to make that mean heap. दैट इज आई एम गिविंग द नेम क्यू. इट इज वर्टिसेस, जी डॉट वर्टिसेस. क्यू इज ए मीन हीप. क्यू इज ए मीन हीप. तो we have constructed a mean heap. Now while q not equal to empty, while q not equal to empty, I will always take the minimum node which is based on the key. Based on the key it is sorting. Okay, means mean heap is having the value, how it will sort, that which element will be at the minimum at the node according to their key value. So it's r dot key is going, first is key, r is going to be at the root and rest is going to be in the next level. Okay, so you will extract the minimum, and that I am putting on u. Extract mean from q, that is going to be here. Now it is u that you have extracted. Now for each vertex v adjacent to u, you will calculate. Okay, right, first let me write it. If v belongs to q and cost of uv is smaller than v dot key, then v parent is going to your u, and v dot key going to your weight of u and v. This is closed here. Yes. And finally, now let me explain. So first you write it down. If you're done with the writing, then you let me know, then I will explain. Here near work is the parent, v dot parent. Cost is going to have in v dot key. Okay, so with example I will make it more clear. Now take an example. You are having an array like this. So in today class people are facing difficulties, that's why no one is commenting anything. See, in gate exam some topic will be difficult. This is little bit difficult topic, means the code is a little bit difficult. Okay, the one thing that you can do, you can remember the, if you are not able to understand the code, you just mug the time complexity. You should remember the time complexity. Okay, the time complexity is important. So it's 1, 2, 6, 7, 5, 4, same tree, I think it is the same tree, same graph, it is there, 25 24 82 18 here 16 here 2. Now first see what it is doing. It is saying that g is a graph and cost they have given, r is any vertices. Now for every vertex u that belongs to the graph, u dot key and u dot parent is going to be null. So u dot q means you write here 1 2 3 4 5 6. Here it is going to your key and parent. Pi is your parent and this is your key. So initially it is doing every key value, it's saying infinity. Every key value it is saying infinity, and parent it is saying nil. Initially it is doing that. It is doing. Okay, now it is doing, it is taking any node, it is starting. See this implementation with mean heap here, it will start from any node. Here it is not required that you should start, you will choose the first first edge which is having a list. You can start from any node. यू आर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम आर, यू आर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम आर विच इज हैविंग लिस्ट वेट. सो आर इज योर वन, आर इज योर, आई एम चूजिंग आर एज वन, आई एम चूजिंग, यू कैन चूज एनी वन. हेयर आई एम चूजिंग, लेट्स एज्यूम हेयर, let's assume here r as 1. So I am assuming r as 1. Let's assume here r as 1. You can choose anyone. I am choosing here 1. So here r means the start node from where you are going to start your code. So you are taking r as 1. So it's saying that you make r dot key as 0. You will make r dot key as 0. R dot key as 0. And you have done it. And now you are going to make a mean heap. So you are going to make a Q is a mean heap, okay, and you are making the mean heap, and they are sorted by means by which value they will put the element in the first or in the by key value. So you know that r dot key is only 0, so means 1 is only having a key 0 and rest is having infinity. So it will like this. One will be here and rest will be like this. Rest will be like this. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Like this it will have in any order. Okay. That is not our concern. But what we know that minimum will be at the root and that is going to be your 1. That is going to be your 1. Now see what it is saying. Now you will execute this while loop. Okay. I think that till now it is clear. Now we will execute this while loop. Q is your mean heap till it is having some element. Now you will extract the minimum. You have extracted. So first you have extracted 1. You have extracted 1. Okay. You have extracted 1. Now it's saying for each vertex V adjacent to U. Now for each vertex V adjacent to U. So the vertex which is adjacent to U, 1 is your 6 and 2. 6 and 2. Now take the, if V belongs to Q, take the cost of U and V. Is it smaller than V cost? Cost of U is a cost of 1, 6. Is it smaller than cost of V dot key. So V is your 6 dot key. 6 dot key. Means, now since you have added first in the spanning tree node 1, now you are here again you are finding that previously its cost, everyone cost is infinity. Now by adding 1, whether its cost is going to change or not, like from 1 to 6, 1 if you will see here it's 1 cost, 1 key is your 0, 1 key is your 0, okay, means cost is 0. Now it's saying that the next vertex V, cost of uv, u is your 1 and V is your adjacent vertex. U is your 1 and V is the adjacent of that, so two vertices are adjacent. So cost of 1, 6, is it smaller than cost V dot key? V is your 6 dot key is your infinity, and cost of 1 and 6 is your 10. Yes, it is smaller, means the parent of 6 should be 1, means you should go to 6 through 1, not through nil. Okay, and the cost is going to be 10. So now that I am going to update. So v dot parent is going to be 1. So 6 dot parent is going to be your 1, and its cost is going to be uv. Is 1 and its parent, 1 minute, is just a minute. One and its parent cost is your 10, okay, because 1 to 6 is your 10 and parent is your work.
This way we have constructed. So please let me know whether it is clear or not.
Hey, clear hai ki nahi bataiye. Otherwise, it clear or not? Now you will have the next vertex is your 2. Now for 2, for every vertex that is adjacent, we are going to compare to 1. Okay. Now see, 2 is here, 2 is here. Okay. Now for each vertex V adjacent to you, 2 is also adjacent. Okay. Now 2, 1 and 2, 1 and 2 cost. We'll compare that Now for 2 we are going to see cost of 1 and 2. V is your now 2. Okay, 6 I have taken 6. 6 was cost was 10 and it's near 2. Now 2 I am taking 2 and 1. And here it's saying V dot key. V is your 2, 2 dot key. So 2 dot key is your infinity and cost of 2 and 1 is 20. Yes, it's smaller. So now 3 is near 2, means 3 is 3 par- sorry, 2 parent is now 1. 2 parent is 1. 2 parent is 1. 2 parent is going to your 1. Here it should be 1 and its cost is going to a 20. That I am doing here. V dot parent is your 1, u, and v dot key is going to weight of that. Weight of u. Okay, that I have taken. Now you will again take the minimum from the q. Again, this while q not equal to empty, while q is having something. The q is having total number of vertices. Now again you will take the next node which is having a minimum weight. Okay, minimum weight according to the key. So 6 is going to be added because its key value is 10. So now after 1 you will going to add 6 here, which is having 10. Now again every vertices which is adjacent to v you will calculate cost. Will again do the same thing. Now is your u. U is your now 6. U is your now 6. Now u is your now 6. Okay. Now for each vertex v adjacent to u. So it is having 1 and 3. Adjacent is 1 and 3. 1 and 3 and 7 is also adjacent. 7 is also adjacent. 7 is also. Okay. Now see, you are not going to consider again 1. Why? Because you have deleted 1. You have deleted 1. So it will be, now after that, it will be not. 1 will be not there because you have deleted. And you have also deleted 6. You have also deleted 6 because you have added. So now it's near, it means adjacent is going to be 3 and 7. Adjacent is going to be 3 and 7. Then again you will compare cost of, again you will compare for each vertex v adjacent to you will compare cost of u and v, cost of 3 and 4. Is it smaller than 3 dot key? So 3 dot key is infinity and 3 to 4 is your 3 to your v is your 6. So it's going to be 1 minute. So 6 adjacent is not 3, its adjacent is 5 only. Sorry, only 5 it will be. Adjacent is only v is going to only 5 because 6 adjacent is only this 5. Okay, so it will be. Will be 5 and 6 and 5 key. So 5 key is your infinity and cost of 5 6 is your 25. 5 6 is your 25. Now 25, is it smaller than infinity? Yes, 25 is smaller than. Now so 5 parent is going to change. 5 parent is going to change. सो फाइव पेरेंट इज नाउ गोइंग टू योर सिक्स एंड इट्स कॉस्ट इज गोइंग टू योर 20 कॉस्ट इज ओके नाउ यू विल टेक द नेक्स्ट नोट विच इज हैविंग ए लिस्ट वेट सो फाइव वी आर गोइंग टू ऐड फाइव वी आर गोइंग टू ऐड विच इज हैविंग ए कॉस्ट 25 So in this way, again, you will see the vertex next, which is adjacent to you. For each vertex V, which is adjacent to you, again, you are going to do. So for each vertex V adjacent to you. So now you have chosen, now your U is your 5. Now your U is your 5. Oh, I should write here. This. Oh, this key is representing like 28, 1. infinity n at 25 and 6 not be anything and you have deleted 5 because you have deleted 5 so it should not be nothing here it should be empty okay. now for every vertex v which is adjacent to 5 5 adjacent to 6 6 you have deleted already 7 and 4 now you will check that U V cost is it smaller than V key? V key V is your 7. So first you will compare 7 and 5. Is it cost 7 and 4 is cost is your 7 and 5. 7 and 5 cost is your 24 and 7 key is your infinity. Yes, it's a small. So 7 parent is now 5. 7 parent is now 5. 7 parent is now 5. It's 5. 7 parent is now 5 and parent is here 7 parent is 5 and its cost is going to your 24 cost is going to your 20 okay cost is going to your 24 you are adding 7 through 5 okay now similarly we will check for 4 similarly 7 we have checked now we will check for 4 we'll check for 4 4, 5 and 5 key. 4 I have added. 4 key. 4. 4 is the addition. You will check which value is smaller. So 4 to 5 is your 22 and 4 key is infinity. That's why we are in the beginning, we are making as infinity so that we can add the next node. Okay. So the parent, 4 parent is now going to your 5. 4 parent is now going to your 4 parent is going to your and its cost is going to your okay now you will again extract the minimum so now the minimum will be node 4 now you are going to add node 4 which is having the cost 22 having the cost okay so you have deleted 4 delete that so this is your queue only okay this is your queue only. Now the nodes which is adjacent to so U is your now 4. The nodes which is adjacent to U is your 7 and 3. 7 is there in the system means in queue and 3 is also in the queue. That's why see that's why here I am saying that the nodes which is adjacent for every vertex V adjacent to U, V should be in the queue because if you have deleted that vertex, then no need to consider that. Now we'll check cost of U and V and V dot. So 7 cost of 4 3 we are going 4 and 7 we are going to consider and we'll check that 7 key. Okay. So if I go to 7 through 4, its cost is 18 and previously 7 was going through 5. 7 was going through 5, its cost was 24. Cost was 24. Means it's near 7 near is 4. 7 near is I will up. If it is smaller, then what I am doing? If it is smaller, then V dot parent is U, and V dot key is your weight of U and V. Okay. So it is going to change. Now parent is your 4, and weight is going to your weight of 4 and 7. Weight of 4 and 7 is 8. Now similarly, we will do for 3. Will be 3 here and it will be here 3. I think now it will be clear. Is it clear now? Now cost of 4 and 3 is your 12 and previously cost of 3 is infinity. So now पेरेंट इज नाउ गोइंग टू चेंज टू फोर, थ्री पेरेंट इज नाउ गोइंग टू चेंज टू फोर एंड इट्स कॉस्ट इज गोइंग टू बी, थ्री पेरेंट इज नाउ गोइंग टू चेंज टू फोर एंड इट्स कॉस्ट इज गोइंग टू योर थ्री, कॉस्ट इज गोइंग टू योर ट्वेल्व. ओके नाउ यू विल, नाउ अगेन इट विल इट डन, अगेन यू विल टेक द मिनिमम till the time q is having some element. So you are having q, you are having 3 element. Now again take extract mean. So you will extract 3 which is having 12. So you will extract 3 which is having 12 because parent is your 4. So from 4 it is going to be corrected. Now you have deleted. Deleted 3. Now u is your, now in this case now u is your 3. Okay. So now the nodes which is adjacent to 3. Okay. So the adjacent that is going to be adjacent to this is 2. 4 is not going to be adjacent because 4 you have deleted. 4 is going to be adjacent, but here it will get rejected because V is not in Q. 4 is not in Q. Okay. Because mean, in mean heap you have deleted 4. So only vertex that is adjacent to the node. Node 3 is your 2. Okay. Now we will compare that 2, 3 cost and 2 Q. It's now 28 and 1. If you will go to node 2 through 1, its cost is 28. Now we're checking if you will go node 2, 3, 3, what is going to be the cost? Cost is 16. Initially, previously it is having 18. So since it is 16, if you will go through 3, it's 16. So you will not consider this. It is going to be your 16. And now near of that parent now is going to change. So 2 parent is now 3. Now again, this I have written. If its cost is smaller than V dot key, so V parent is going to your U and V dot key is going to be changed. Weight, new weight. Okay. Okay, so now you will again this work done. Now again extract mean q, again you are going to extract mean q. So now you will extract which node? You will extract the node 2 because its cost is 16. So you will extract 2. So 2 is, 2 parent is your 3. So through 3 your cost is 16. Now you will delete this. Now the nodes you have considered as 2. Now the nodes which is adjacent to u is your 1 and 7. 1 you have already deleted. Now 7 you are going to consider. Now you will check cost of u and v, whether is it smaller than v dot key. So cost u is your 2 and v is your 7 and 7 dot key is your 18. Means if you will go through 7 from 4, its cost is 18. But if you will go from 2 to 7, its cost is 14. 14 is smaller than 18. So now it's going to update its parent. Its parent is now not 4. So previously 7 parent was 4. Now its parent will be 2 because its cost is 14. So we will change it. It will be 2 and 14. Parent is now going to your 2 and cost is going to have 14. So now you will delete again 7. You are going to connect from 2 because its parent is 2, cost is 1. So this way it is going to work and you are going to get the mean. Okay, this is the implementation by using mean. Okay. Always you will construct a mean by using a key and you will delete the extract mean and you will choose the adjacent vertices adjacent to u. And we'll compute that by if we'll get this vertex, new vertex, is it value is going to be decreased or not? Okay. So v dot parent, if it is decreased, then your update is going to be changed. V dot parent is going to your u and v dot key is going to your. Please let me know whether it is clear or not. So here g is your graph. Now we will try to find the time complexity. So this is for each vertex u that belongs to vertex, you are going to do some initialization. This is the initialization part you are doing. एवरी इफ यू आर हैविंग ए वी वर्टेक्स इट इज गोइंग टू टेक बिग ऑफ वी. ओके बिग ऑफ वी. नाउ हेयर यू आर गोइंग टू कंस्ट्रक्ट मीन हिप एंड वर्टेक्स इज वी. सो यू नो दैट कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ मीन हिप इज गोइंग टू टेक बिग ऑफ वी. वट एवर विल बी द नंबर ऑफ नोड्स दैट इज गोइंग टू बी द टाइम कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी टू बिल्ड ए मीन हिप. सो इफ इट इज हैविंग वी वर्टेक्स इट इज गोइंग टू बी बिग ऑफ वी. नाउ टिल द टाइम इट इज हैविंग समथिंग q not equal to int, you are going to, so this is going to run till big O of v times, okay, and you are always going to extract the minimum. Minimum is going to your take big O of log n, okay, and this you are taking for each vertex v adjacent to u, and the vertex if it's adjacent, if it's belongs to q, then you are decreasing the key value, and decreasing the key value, it's like decrease key. So this is not going to run to always v times, okay, for every h it is going to run. Okay, see, first tell me how much time this is going to be run. Tell me how much time it is going to be run. You think what is going to be the time complexity of this? First tell me, think you, for each vertex v adjacent to you are going to this, and you are going to here you are going to do decrease key. You are going to do decrease key. So you can say that decrease key time complexity is log v, log of n. Okay, log of n. N is the number of nodes. But it is not always it is going to be like that. Okay, always it is not going to be like that. Why? Why it is not? Tell me anyone. Every time this decrease key is going to take log of v, whatever will be the time complexity is going to take log of v only. Okay, whatever, but how much number of times you are going to execute, you can say that sir it is going to run for v times, and this is mean decrease key is time complexity is log of v. See what here we are doing, we are decreasing the key value, and decrease key we have seen in case of heap that it is going to take the time as log of n. Whatever will be the number of nodes, n is the number of nodes. N number of nodes is v, but its time complexity is not going to v into log v. V into log. This extract mean is going to be v into log n. That is, you can write as v going to be log v. V log v it is going to be extract, because this while loop is going to run till v times. And always you are going to extract the minimum, or whenever you extract the minimum means like delete mean is taking a log of v times. Now we are taking always the node which is adjacent and which is in the tree, minimum spanning tree means in the that mean heap. If you have deleted that, then you are not going to consider. Okay, now for it means for every edge you are going to decrease, for every edge. So this is going to run till e times, because if you have deleted any node, you are not going to again consider, na? So this is not going to run. If you see the aggregate analysis is saying that if you will see in a bigger picture, it is not going to run v. See, extract mean is going to run till v into log v, because v times we are running, and decrease key is going to run, you can say that v into log v, you can say v into log v. Okay, but it is not like this. Why? Because for every vertex we are not doing the decrease key. For every vertex we are not going, means always in worst case it can be adjacent to all the v vertex. In worst case it can be adjacent to all the v minus 1 vertices. It can be, but if you have deleted any vertex, then again you are not going to consider. Means if you will delete this vertex, yes correct Madhura, because if you are deleting any vertex we are not considering. So according to the whatever will be the number of A's that you are going to consider, whatever will be the number of A's that you are going to consider. So it seems from the code that it is going to run till B minus 1 times, but it is going to run till E times. It's going to run till E times. So it's going to your E log B. You'll see in aggregate analysis, it is going to your E log B. Is it clear? Okay, jitne bar A's rahega, utne bar hi na karenge. आपने तो जब अगर आप जब जब आप वन लिए, देखिए जब आप ऐड किए वन, ऐड वन किए, इसका जो उसके साथ जो जो वर्टिस एडजेसेंट था आपने कर दिए, ठीक है, सिक्स और फाइव था, सिक्स और टू था, आपने वहां पे किए एडजेसेंट जो था. तो आप देखिए हर बार जितना वर्टिक्स एडजेसेंट है कर दिए, तो उसके बाद क्या आप जब इसको आप क्या किए, फिर सिक्स ऐड किए ना, फिर सिक्स ऐड किए, आपने ऐड किया इसका अमाउंट टेन बता दिया. अब आपको ऐड क्या करना है, फाइव. अब आप फाइव ऐड करेंगे, ठीक है. सॉरी सर, अगर टू डी मैट्रिक्स में किए तो एन स्क्वायर होगा. टू डी मैट्रिक्स हमने उस तरह किए हैं जब हमने मीन हीप यूज नहीं करते तो वी स्क्वायर लगता है, जब मीन हीप यूज नहीं करते तो वी स्क्वायर लगता है. लेकिन जब मीन हीप यूज करते हैं तो जैसे अब जैसे आप आपने उसके बाद सिक्स को ऐड किए, सिक्स को आप ऐड किए ना, उसके बाद आप तो सिक्स को डिलीट कर दे रहे हो, आप तो सिक्स को डिलीट कर दे रहे हो, वन को भी डिलीट कर दे रहे हो. तो जब नोड फाइव का एडजेसेंट वर्टेक्स सिक्स और सेवन फोर था, लेकिन अब तो ये डिलीट हो गया ना, अब तो इसको कंसिडर नहीं करोगे. देखो हर एज एक ही बार आ रहा है, ये एज एक बार कंसिडर हुआ, ये एज भी एक बार कंसिडर हुआ, ये एज भी, हर एज एक ही बार कंसिडर हो रहा है रिलैक्सिंग में, एक ही बार कंसिडर हो, दो बार नहीं हो रहा है. देखिए तीन बार नहीं हो रहा क्योंकि ये डिलीट हो गया है, ये भी डिलीट हो गया है. क्लियर, समझ में आ रहा है इमाम? देखिए तो जब फाइव का होगा तो सेवन और सिक्स का किए तो फिर फाइव डिलीट हो जाता है, जब फोर का करेंगे तो फाइव को कंसिडर नहीं करेंगे, ये इसको कंसिडर करेंगे थ्री को और सेवन. देखिए ये नो, ये आया एज, ये आया, देखिए जितना बार एज आ रहा है उतने बार हो रहा है. फिर इसको डिलीट करेंगे तो देखिए थ्री को जब करेंगे तो इसके तो कंसिडर नहीं करेंगे ना, क्योंकि ये तो डिलीट हो गया, ये तो डिलीट हो गया. जब भी कोई नोट डिलीट हो जाएगा तो उसके साथ उसको तो एज भी डिलीट कर दिया, तो जितना एज है उतना ही हो रहा है ना. देखिए रिलैक्सिंग कितने बार हम डिक्रीज कर रहे हैं, जितना बार एज है. आप एग्रीगेट देखिए, जैसे ये वन है, वन का एज यहाँ था और यहाँ था, तो ये दोनों किए, अब वन डिलीट कर दिया, अब वन डिलीट हो गया, तो क्या ये और ये दोबारा आएगा? नहीं आएगा, नहीं आएगा. अब सिक्स बचा, अब सिक्स जब करेंगे तो ये तो नहीं होगा क्योंकि डिलीट हो गया, ये डिलीट हो गया, ये डिलीट हो गया, ये तो नहीं हो गया. अब सिक्स का करेंगे, सिक्स का जब किए तो ये कंसिडर नहीं, ये किए, ठीक. अब सिक्स डिलीट करेंगे तो सिक्स डिलीट करेंगे तो ये भी तो गया ना, तो जब फाइव का कैलकुलेट कर रहे हैं तो अब इसको कंसिडर नहीं करेंगे. तो जो डिक्रीज की हम लोग जो यहाँ पे बार बार कर रहे हैं, उसको डिक्रीज की जब कॉस्ट देख रहे हैं, डिक्रीज की कर रहे हैं, यहाँ पे कर रहे हैं, ये डिक्रीज की है, ये क्या काम कर रहे हैं, ये डिक्रीज की कर रहे हैं. जब भी आप देख रहे हैं कि जो उसका कॉस्ट है, उसका नया पेरेंट से जो आ रहा है उसका कॉस्ट कम है, उसका की वैल्यू को आप कम करते रहे नया से, तो जो क्या हो गया, की वैल्यू को जब कम कर रहे हैं तो उसको क्या कहते हैं, डिक्रीज की. तो डिक्रीज की का टाइम लॉग इन टाइम होता है, लेकिन ये लूप तो वी नंबर ऑफ टाइम्स तो नहीं चल रहा है, ये तो चल रहा है ई टाइम्स. तो ये क्या हो गया, ई लॉग बी. एग्रीगेट अगर देखेंगे तो ई लॉग बी हो गया, ठीक है, क्यों बार बार तो वी वर्टिसेस नहीं रहेंगे. समझ में आ रहा है? अब शायद मुझे लग रहा है क्लियर हो गया होगा. इमाम क्लियर है क्या? इमाम क्लियर है क्या बताइएगा? इज इट क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू? प्लीज लेट मी नो. Is it clear to all of you? Please let me know. So its time complexity. What is going to be its time complexity? So its time complexity here. Time complexity is going to here. If you see here, it is for this initialization. It's taking big of v. Big of v. Now you are doing build heap. That is going to take big of v for build heap. Now for decrease key, you are doing here two work. One is delete minimum, that is strict, that is V log V it is taking, V log V, that is V log V. And the another work that is you are doing is the decrease key. And decrease key you are doing E number of times, and every number of times it is going to take E log V. Every number of times it is going to take E log V. So total time complexity is going to your E log V. E. So that we got. We got without using mean heap, without using mean heap. So if we are not going to use mean heap, then we are going to get time complexity as E log. If we are not going to use mean heap, means if you are going to use using mean heap, we are going to get time complexity as E log B. एंड इफ विल यूज इफ यू नॉट यूज विदाउट मीनिंग दिस ई इज ग्रेटर देन वी ओके दैट्स इट्स डोमिनेटिंग फैक्टर ई इज ग्रेटर देन वी दैट्स व्हाई आई एम टेकिंग ई लॉग वी एंड विदाउट मीन हीप वी हैव सीन द टाइम दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट ओके विदाउट मीन हीप सर बट ए मोर देन एन माइनस वन एजेस एट करेगा ना सर बट ए मोर नहीं एन माइनस वन एजेस से ज्यादा कभी नहीं होगा क्योंकि स्पैनिंग ट्री में अगर एन वर्टिसेस होगा तो एन माइनस वन ही है ना एजेस होगा एन माइनस वन एजेस से ज्यादा कभी वो ऐड करेगा ही नहीं क्योंकि तब तो गड़बड़ हो गया तब तो एक ट्री में अगर एन नोड्स है तो एन माइनस वन ही एजेस होगा हाँ वो जितना एजेस है उतना सबको कंसिडर करेगा सबका उसका रिलैक्सिंग करेगा अगर ई एजेस है तो ई एजेस का वो रिलैक्सिंग कर रहा है ठीक है मतलब वो रिलैक्सिंग हम यहाँ क्या बोले डिक्रीज की कर रहा ठीक है तो विदाउट मीन हीप क्या हमने देखा कि वी स्क्वायर एक फिबोनाची हीप होता है फिबोनाची हीप हमारे सिलेबस में नहीं है अगर हम फिबोनाची हीप करेंगे तो टाइम कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी हमारा लगेगा वी लॉग वी प्लस ही ये सिर्फ मैं आपका नॉलेज के लिए बता रहा हूं फिबोनाची हीप ओके अगर फिबोनाची हीप हम यूज करेंगे तो हमारा टाइम कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी हो जाएगा वी लॉग वी प्लस ये सिर्फ नॉलेज के लिए दिस इज फॉर नॉलेज नॉट फॉर योर गेट ओके सी प्लीज लेट मी नो वेदर इट इज क्लियर और नॉट चलिए क्लियर है कि नहीं सबको बताइए हमने दोनों इंप्लीमेंटेशन देख लिए जब हमने मीन हीप यूज किए तो हमें टाइम कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी ई लॉग भी लगा जब मीन हीप हम यूज नहीं किए तो हमें वी स्क्वायर लगा ठीक है तो ये याद रखना है ये दोनों बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है टाइम कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है तो विदाउट यूजिंग मीन हीप इज योर वी स्क्वायर विथ मीन हीप इज गोइंग टू योर ई लॉग वी नाउ now you give a point and now we will compare these two okay so if you write this if all the edges are of distinct if all the edges are of distinct cost then by applying so dekhiye aapne dono tarika dekh liye So if you'll use, if you can apply both method, you will get always the same answer. Okay, you can apply anything. So if all the edges are distinct cost, then by applying any algorithm, we are going to get same minimum spanning tree. We are always going to get same minimum spanning tree. And if one or two edges have same weight. Then we may get one or more spanning tree. But minimum cost will be same. So this is the conclusion. Where I am saying that if all the edges are of distinct cost, then by applying any algorithm, we are going to get the same minimum spanning tree. So if we apply any algorithm, we are always going to get the same minimum spanning tree. But if one or two edges have the same weight, then we may get more than one spanning tree, one or more spanning tree. But minimum cost will be same. Now tell me whether it is done or not. If you are done with the writing, then please let me know. Now we will compare. Prim's algorithm with mean heap and without mean heap. We have seen the time complexity. Now we will do the comparison. Both comparison. So today we are going to finish this Prim's algorithm. Pair करते हैं. देखिए, ये comparison बहुत जरूरी है. कब देखिए? आपने तो दोनों देख लिए. We have seen both the implementation. Now which implementation we should use in which case? Now see comparison of time complexity of Prim's algorithm without देखिए, अगर समझ में नहीं आया होगा आज का क्लास तो आप इसे फिर से रिवाइज देखिएगा, यू कैन अगेन वॉच इट विथ विदाउट मीनिंग एंड विथ विदाउट मीनिंग एंड विथ मीनिंग. नाउ व्हेन टू यूज, ओके, सो विदाउट हीप, विदाउट मीन हीप, this is your without mean heap. When to use without mean heap, in which graph you will use without mean heap and which graph you will use with mean heap. Okay, without mean heap, without mean heap here, with mean heap. So here you are getting without mean heap, the time complexity is going to your v square, is your v square, and here you are getting e log, e log, here you are getting e log. Okay, now if I will give you a dense graph, dense graph means the number of edges are more. In dense graph, in dense graph, in dense graph, what is in dense graph? The edges is going to your, the E is going to your V square. In dense graph, E is going to your, number of edges are going to be more. Then in dense graph, the time complexity is going to your, here it's going to take V square only because it's independent of edges. And here it is going to be v square log v. In dense graph, it is going to be ev square, and time complexity is going to be here v square, and here it is going to be v square log. So in case of dense graph, we should use Prim's algorithm implementation. This kind of question they will ask in your gate exam. That which implementation you should use in case of dense graph. In case of dense graph, we should use without mean heap. Without mean heap. Why? Because without mean heap, time complexity is big O V square. With mean heap, time complexity is E log. E log. So E is going to, in case of dense graph, E is going to your V square. So it will going to take V square log, which is very much than V square. So we use Prim's algorithm implementation without mean heap. That's why we are having two implementation. That's why we have seen that without meaning. Okay. So in case of dense graph, we are going to use this without meaning. Now in case of sparse graph. Now what is sparse graph? When number of edges is less, where E is equal to V only. If you are done with the writing and if you understood it, please comment. If you have understood it, if you are done with the writing, then please comment. Okay, so both implementation we have seen. Now we are doing the comparison. In case of a sparse tree, E is going to your V. Number of edges is equal to number of vertices. E is equal to V. So then, in case of without mean heap, it's going to take time complexity as without mean heap. Here it is going to take time complexity as big O of, in case of E, it is going to V square only. It is independent of that. And with mean heap is going to your take, in sparse tree, E is equal to V. So it is going to your V E log V. The time complexity is E log V. With mean heap is E log V. Now since it is a sparse tree, in place of E, you will write V log. So V square is more bigger value than V log. So in case of a sparse tree, you should use implementation with mean. So this kind of question they will ask you in your gate exam. In case of a sparse tree, which implementation should we should use so that we can get a less time complexity? We will get V log V in case of sparse tree when it is, we will use the implementation with mean. So in case of a sparse tree, we should use Prim's algorithm. Prim's algorithm implementation विदाउट विथ मीनिंग विथ मीनिंग. इज इट क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू? इज इट क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू? प्लीज लेट मी नो वेदर यू आर डन विथ whether you are done with the writing or not. So your Prim's algorithm is completed. We have seen all the two different kind of implementation. We have even compared it. We have even seen the time complexity. Okay. अगर graph disjoint होगा तो कभी spanning tree मिलेगा ही नहीं, ठीक है? क्योंकि graph अगर disjoint है, spanning tree क्या होता है? Tree क्या है? Connected. Graph disjoint है तो कभी हमें मिलेगा ही नहीं, ठीक है? Disjoint graph के लिए हम spanning tree नहीं बना सकते. ट्री तो कनेक्टेड होता नहीं, ट्री इज ए कनेक्टेड ए साइक्लिक ग्राफ, कनेक्टेड होगा साइकिल नहीं होगा, ठीक है? तो